This message, Who is This? By Brother William Marion Branham was delivered on Sunday morning, October the 4th, 1959, at the Faith Assembly in Clarksville, Indiana, USA. Hierdie boodskap, Wie is hierdie, deur Brother William Marion Branham, oorspronklik gelewer in Engels op Sondagoggend, 4 Oktober 1959 by die Geloofgemeente in Clarksville, Indiana, VSA.
Lord, the things that he has promised and every promise that he has made is true, and we are looking forward to the time of his appearing. And as we see that day approaching, that hour coming, it makes us want to check up, take inventory of ourselves and just see where we are standing.
Here en die dinge wat hy beloof het, en elke belofte wat hy gemaak het is waar, en ons sien uit na die tyd van sy verskyning, en soos ons daardie dag sien nader kom, daardie uur wat kom, veroorsaak dit dat ons wil nagaan, inventaris wil maak van onsself, en het sien waar ons staan.
I just was hearing, had I come in the yard out there, my good friend there, that a real buddy of mine is near death with cancer. And I certainly want the church to pray for Brother Rogers.
Ek het so pas gehoor toe ek by die agterplaas ingekom het daar buite my goeie vriend daar, dat 'n ware vriend van my op sterwe is met kanker. En ek wil beslis hê die kerk moet bid vir Brother Rogers.
And he is, I want to go down this week to see him. He lives in a city about 35-40 miles below here, Milltown, Indiana. And I want to go down and see him.
En hy is, ek wil afgaan hierdie week om hom te sien. Hy woon in 'n stad omtrent 35-40 mile onder toe hier, Milltown, Indiana. En ek wil afgaan en hom sien.
He's a veteran of the First World War, and he had surgery just recently, and the doctors just sewed him up because they said there's no need of trying to operate. He was dying. And he just learned about it, I believe, Friday or Saturday one, that he just learned that he had cancer.
He's a veteran van die Eerste Wêreldoorlog, en hy het net onlangs 'n operasie ondergaan. Die dokters het hom net toegewerk, want hulle het gesê dat die help glad nie om te opereer nie, hy is stervende. En hy het dit so pas uitgevind, glo ek, Vrydag of Saterdag een, dat hy pas gehoor het dat hy kanker het.
But one great thing happened. He said in the room when he went into the hospital that there was a rainbow came in the corner, and he stood and looked at it for some time. And that was God's sign of a covenant. Of course, the rainbow is always represents a covenant.
Maar een groot ding het gebeur. Hy het gesê in die kamer toe hy in die hospitaal ingegaan het, dat daar 'n reënboog in die hoek verskyn het. En hy het vir 'n lang tyd daarna staan en kyk. Dit was God se teken van 'n verbond, natuurlik. Die reënboog, dit verteenwoordig altyd 'n verbond.
God keeps his covenants, he makes his promise. You and I can make one and have to break it because we just don't know what tomorrow holds. But God cannot make one and break it because he knows what tomorrow holds.
God hou sy verbonde. Hy maak sy belofte. En ek en jy kan een maak en dit moet verbreek, want ons weet net nie wat môre inhou nie. Maar God kan nie een maak en dit verbreek nie, want hy weet wat môre inhou, sien?
He knows all about our troubles and what is, and he knows all that would be before it was. Before the foundation of the world, he knew just exactly who would be and who would not be.
Hy ken al ons probleme en wat dit is. En hy het alles geweet wat sou wees nog voor dit was. Voor die grondleg van die wêreld het geweet net presies wie sou wees en wie nie sou wees nie.
And isn't it a comfort after we just had these great stern talks from this Russian Khrushchev and the different ones and the remarks that they have made that says the hangars is ready, they could destroy the world within just a minute. And just anything, they could just press a button and that would be all of it.
En is dit nie 'n troos, nadat ons hierdie groot ernstige toesprake gehad het, van hierdie Rus Khrushchev en die verskillendes nie, en die opmerkings wat hulle gemaak het, wat sê die loodse is gereed, hulle kan die wereld vernietig binnen net 1 minuut sien, en net enig iets, hulle druk net 'n knoppie, en dit sal alles verby wees.
But to look in the pages of this Bible and see, but before that can ever happen, the church has gone home. Oh, what a feeling. See, what a relief to know. That'll never touch us.
Amen.
That's right. It'll never touch us. We're just as safely as it can be.
Maar om in die bladsy van hierdie Bybel te kyk en te sien, maar voor dit ooit kan gebeur, is die kerk huis toe. O, wat 'n gevoel sien, wat 'n verligting om te weet, dat hulle ons nooit sal aanraak nie. Dis reg, dit sal ons nooit raak nie. Ons is net so veilig as wat dit kan wees.
And to know that that isn't just some hiding place that the government has formed for us, it's a hiding place that God has formed. And we can rest assured that it's just as perfect as it can be.
En om te weet dat dit nie net een of ander skuilplek is wat die regering vir ons gemaak het nie, dis 'n skuilplek wat God het, en ons kan in sekerheid rus dat dit net so volmaak is as wat dit kan wees.
Down through the ages, God has made promises, and through these promises, He's always kept them.
Amen.
And as for myself, I don't see nothing left but the just quick catching away of the church. I see the little groups going around struggling, the faithful holding on.
Deur die eeuwen heen het God beloftes gemaakt, en deur hierdie beloftes het hy hulle altyd gehou. En sover dit my betref, sien ek niks oor om te gebeur, behalwe net die spoedige wegraping van die kerk nie. Ek sien die groepies wat rondgaan, wat sikkel en getrou is, wat vashou.
And last week, you know what taking place in Israel, the last sign. Israel became a nation in 1947. On the same night the angel Lord visit me. When he came to me at 12 o'clock, it was noon when they signed that peace pact with the world and the League of Nations and so forth overseas.
Nie hulle weet wat verlede week gebeur het in Israel, die laaste teken. Israel het in 1947 'n volk geword op dieselfde aand wat die engel van die Here my besoek het. Toe dit na my toe gekom het, om 12 uur was dit middag, toe hulle daardie vredesverdrag onderteken het met die wêreld, die Volkebond en so voorts oor see.
But last week they got their own currency. They got a regular Jewish money that they use now. And I don't see nothing at all left according to Scripture. Of course, there may many things maybe the Lord not let me know. But I don't see nothing left but just the coming of the Lord.
Amen.
Maar verlede week het hulle eie geld eenheid gekry, hulle het 'n gewone Joodse geld wat hulle nou gebruik, en ek sien niks anders wat oor is volgens die skrif nie. Natuurlik mag daar baie ding miskien wat die Here my nie laat weet nie, maar ek sien niks oor behalwe net die koms van die Here nie.
And oh, how I just like to check up. You get to reading the papers and listening to newscasts and makes you real nervous, and then sit down and think before it can all happen, we're gone home.
En o, hoe ek net daarvan hou om na te gaan. Jy begin die koerant te lees na die nuus uitsendings luister en maak jou baie senuweeagtig. En gaan dan sit en dink voordat alles kan gebeur as ons weg huis toe.
I'll be never an old person in that country. Just think we old people will be changed then.
Amen.
And we'll be young. There can never be a sickness there, never be death, there can never be a sorrow, heartache, or anything at that time when we've crossed that.
Daar sal nooit 'n ou persoon in daardie land wees nie, dink net. Ons ou mense sal verander word en ons sal jonk wees. Daar kan nooit 'n siekte daar wees nie, nooit dood nie. Daar kan nooit 'n droefheid, hartseer of enigiets op daardie tyd wees, wanneer ons dit oorgesteek het nie.
Just like to ask this. What if this morning someone could step in the door and say, well, I've just found something scientifically proven the truth.
Wil net graag dit vra. Wat as daar vanmôre iemand by daardie deur kan inkom en sê, "Wel, ek het nou net iets gevind, wetenskaplik bewys as die waarheid."
And That is that there's a ship coming by here through the air just in a few minutes. And every one of you that wants to get on can get on. And it goes to a land I've just returned.
En dit is dat, daar kom een skip hier voorbij deur die lucht binnen net een paar minuten. En elkeen van julle wat wil opklim, kan opklim. En dit gaan naar die land van waar ik pas teruggekeerd het.
I was an old man, 90 years old. And there he is in the very prime of youth, you know, and stand just across there. Just as soon as you step off on that other side, immediately you return back young. And I met people who have been there for millions of years, and they just look the same.
Ek was 'n ou man, 90 jaar oud, en daar is hy in die vleer van jeug, julle weet, en sê, net daaroor kan net so draai afklim, en daar die ander kant is hy onmiddellik weer jong. En ek het mense ontmoet wat daar was vir miljoene jare, en hulle het net dieselfde gelyk.
I say, brother, just make me some room. I'm coming. I think that's the way we all feel, and you know, that isn't just a story, that's the truth.
Ek sou sê, broer, maak net vir my plek sodat ek kan kom. Ek dink, dis hoe ons allemaal voel, en jylle weet, dis nie net een story nie, dis die waarheid.
And the old ship of Zion's going to come down through the air one of these days and load up with saints and cross over and just go beneath the banner of the cross and then we're home. Oh, that great time.
En die oude skip van Sion gaan afkom deur die lucht een van die dae en volmaak met heiliges en oorgaan. Net onder deur die banier gaan die kruis en dan sal ons thuis wees. O, wat grootheid.
So I think today, and you know, even there's many afflictions of the righteous, but God delivereth him out of them all. And I'm glad that we rest assured in this great promise.
So ek dink vandag, en daar is self baie beproewinge van die regverdiges, maar God verlos hulle uit dit alles. En ek is bly dat ons in versekering rus in hierdie groot belofte.
I'm very grateful to God, to His grace that called Brother Junior Jackson, as we know him here. I heard strangers testify a few minutes ago from coming in for the healing service tonight. And I'm very grateful that God saved Brother Jackson.
Ek is baie dankbaar teenoor God vir sy genade wat Brother Junior Jackson geroep het, soos ons hom almal hier ken. Ek het vreemdelinge hoor getuig 'n paar oomblikke gelede om in te kom vir die genesingsdiens vanavond, en ek is baie dankbaar dat God Brother Jackson gered het.
The devil come pretty near killing him one time. But God had a work for him to do, so he spared his life, and that's why this congregation and little church stands here today is for the grace of God.
Die devil het baie na daar aangekom om hom dood te maak een keer, maar God het vromme werk gehad om te doen, so hy het sy lewe gespaar. Dis hoekom hierdie gemeente, kerkie vandag hier staan, is as gevolg van die genade van God.
Junie's been a very dear friend of mine, loyal as he could be to the cause. And I pray that God will bless you people, the congregation here, and will multiply you till this church won't be able to hold the people.
Junie was 'n baie kosbare vriend van my, so getrou as wat ek kon wees vir die saak. En ek bid dat God julle mense sal seën. Die gemeente hier en julle sal vermenigvuldig totdat hierdie kerk nie in staat sal wees om die mense te huisves nie.
And it does me good to get into a little church like this where we can just get close together. I have had the privilege by the grace of God to speak to congregations which is larger, but I don't say this that I enjoyed it anymore. Because the best meetings I've ever had is when we had even little house meetings.
En dit doet my goed om in 'n kerkie soos hierdie in te kom waar ons net naby aan mekaar kan sit. Ek het die voorreg gehad deur die genade van God om te preek in gemeentes wat groter is. Maar ek sê dit nie dat ek dit enigszins meer geniet het nie. Want die beste dienste wat ek ooit gehad het, was wanneer ons selfs huisdiensies gehad het.
Where we just, I get me a chair and get in the corner. Jump off and on the chair and just have a wonderful time of fellowship where the saints can get together.
Waar ons net, ik zou voor mij een stoel kreeg in die hoek ingaan, op en af op die stoel spring. En ik het net een wonderlijke tijd van gemeenschap gehad, maar die heiligen bij elkaar komen.
Wherever two or three are gathered in my name, I'll be in their midst. That's the promise. No matter the size of the church, God promised to meet with us. And he'll do that.
Waar twee of drie vergader is in mijn naam, daar zal ik in hulle midden wees. Dis die belofte, maak nie saak van die grootte van die kerk nie, God het beloof om ons te ontmoet. En hy sal dit doen.
Now, I believe the Brother Jackson was telling me that they were anticipating tonight of having a healing service at the church. And I told him I'd also come down and maybe speak a few minutes to the congregation after his Sunday school lesson this morning and kindly find the feeling of the people.
No, ek glo hulle, Bro Jackson het vir my vertel dat hulle verwag het vanavond om 'n genesingsdienst by die kerk te hê. En ek het vir hom gesê, ek sou ook afkom, miskien 'n paar minute praat met die gemeente na sy sondagskoolles vanmôre in soort van die gevoel van die mense kry.
And I heard someone testify they'd come for healing, and I suppose there'd be many tonight to be prayed for.
En ek het iemand hoor getuig dat hulle gekom het vir genesing. En ek veronderstel daar mag baie wees vanavond om voor gebid te word.
Was you anticipating a service to be just bring the people up and anoint them, pray for them, or a discernment of the Holy Spirit to find the thing that's wrong? And
het jy hulle diens verwag om net die mense nader te bring en hulle te salf vir hulle te bid of 'n onderskeiding van die Heilige Gees om die ding te vind wat verkeerd is en?
See, those things I have to prepare for. Not eating, waiting on the Lord, so forth, because Satan's always near. I have a trap set, just at any time to upset you.
Sien op daardie dinge moet ek voorberei, nie eet nie, wag op die Here, so voort, want Satan is altyd nabij, om 'n lokval te stel, om jou net op enige tyd te ontstel.
How many would feel that it would be best, see, the congregation where this church is like ours up there, a sovereign church. We feel that the majority of the people would have more say-so than just one person. See, because that's what they call casting lot.
En hoeveel sou voel dat dit die beste sou wees, sien die gemeente wat ons. Hierdie kerk is soos ons en daarbo is soewereine kerk. Ons voel dat die meerderheid van die mense meer gesag sou hê as net een persoon sien, want dis wat hulle loodjies trek noem.
Would you think it would be nice to have a discernment service tonight? Raise up your hand if you feel that would be the thing to do, all right? Let's see, now the contrary would it be just, all right?
So you think that it's so good to have net onderscheidingsdienst te hê vanavond? Steek jou hand op as jy voel dat dit die ding sou wees om te doen. Goed, laat ons sien. Nou die teenoorgestelde, sou dit net wees, goed.
We will be giving out the prayer cards then tonight and calling the people. We may be, if there is lots of them, I'll send Gene or Billy or one of them down this afternoon about, what time you start your service? 7:30, 6:30 then. And they'll give you the cards and we'll pray for everybody that's got the cards.
Dan sal ons die gebedskaarte uitdeel vanavond en die mense roep. Daar mag wees, as daar baie van hulle is, sal ek Gene of Billy afstuur of een van hulle vanmiddag omtrent. Hoe laat begin julle diens, Junie? 7:30, 6:30 dan, en hulle sal vir julle kaarte gee, en ons sal vir almal bid wat die kaarte het.
That means everybody be able to be prayed for, but we'll, in a little congregation, but what we'll do, we'll let it rotate in line. I'll tell them to give the prayer cards to the strangers, and then let the home people come next, because it will be the home people close, you see, so they understand.
Dit beteken almal sal voor gebid kan word, maar ons sal in 'n klein gemeentetjie. Maar wat ons sal doen, ons sal dit laat roteer in die ry. Laat. Ek sal vir hulle sê om die gebedskaarte vir die vreemdelinge te gee en dan die plaaslike mense volgende laat kom, want dit sal die naby plaaslike mense wees. Julle sien so, hulle sal hulle verstaan.
Sometimes at home, here it's kind of hard to have a discerning meeting. Miss Wood sitting close now. I went down to the church and I would have a service of, I'd say now, and we may do it that way tonight.
Nou, partijmal hier bij de huis is dit soort van moeilijk om onderscheidingsdiensten. Maar voor goed wat nou besit, ik het onder naar die kerk toe gegaan en ik zou dienst hebben van, ik zou zeggen, nou, ons mag dit soort doen vanavond.
Before there was any prayer cards or anything given out, the Holy Spirit would be near and call out certain people. And I'd say, everybody here is a stranger, stand up. Okay. Let them all stand up.
Voor daar enige gebedskaart of enige iets uitgegeven was, zou de Heilige Geest nabewees en zekere mensen uitroep. En ik zou zeggen, allemaal hier wat een vreemdeling is staan opzien, hulle allemaal laat opstaan.
You'd say, all right, this is so and so from whatever the Holy Spirit would say and do that. And then, the next time I turn around and lots of people here in our city would say, well, we didn't know those people. We didn't know what was the matter with them. That might have been wrong.
Julle zou zeggen, goed, hier is so en so vanaf wat de Heilige Geest ook zou zeggen te doen. En dan zal ik de volgende keer omdraaien bij mensen van hier in ons stad zou zeggen, wel, ons het niet daar die mensen gekend, ons weet niet geweet wat hulle makkeer niet. Dat kon verkeerd geweest het.
Next time, say, all right, we'll just take the folks as home, let them stand up. Why, he know them people. Sure, you know. So you see, Satan has got a trap set everywhere. See, he's ready at any time.
Volgende keer sê, goed, ons sal net die mense vat wat van hier is, hulle laat opstaan. Wel, hy het daar die mense geken, sekerlik hy het geweet. So julle sien, Satan het oor al lokvel gestel, sien, hy is gereed op enige tydstip.
And so, some of them say, well, if you just have that straight discernment like that, the rest of people don't get a chance to get in the prayer line. Some of them say, well, if you have the, I'd rather be prayed for it. Well, it's just vice versa. So we have first one way and then another. And they'll be like that until Jesus comes.
En so partij van hulle sê, wel, as jy net daar die directe onderscheiding soos dit het, krijg die rest van die mensen die kans om in die gebedsreed te kom nie. Sommige hulle sê, wel, as jy het, sal ek liever voor gebid word. Wel, dis net omgekeerd. So ons het eerst een manier en dan die ander, en hulle sal so wees tot Jesus kom.
The gospel always brings a mixed multitude. The effects of the preaching of Christ always brings a mixed multitude. It brings believers, make believers, and unbelievers. That's the congregation that you have. So we expect all of that. So we are looking forward to for tonight being a great time in the Lord.
Jy kan die evangelie bring altyd 'n gemengde skare, die effek van die verkondiging van Christus trek altyd 'n gemengde skare. Dit bring gelowiges, skeyngelowiges en ongelowiges. Dis die gemeente wat jy het. So onverwag dit alles, so ons sien uit na dat vanaand 'n wonderlike tyd in die Here sal wees.
Now, just before we open the word and you allow about 11:30, I suppose, Brother Junior.
Nou, net voordat ons die woord opmaak, hier vandag omtrent 11:30, veronderstel ik, Broer Junior.
And then, them people who wants to be in the prayer line tonight, so they can line them up. If there comes a group for the outside, then we can bring them in, you know, through the doors and so forth. You come at 6:30. Let us bow our heads now before we read the word.
En dan naar die mense wat in gebedsrij wil wees vanavond, so dat hulle kan opleen as daar een groep van buiten kom, dan kan ons hulle inbring julle weer deur die deure en sovoorts. Kom julle om 6:30. Kom ons buig nou ons hoofde voor ons die woord lees.
Our precious Lord, we thank thee most humbly from the depths of our heart for this living hope that we have within this dying body. There is a Lord God and Jesus Christ. And through His mercy and His goodness, He has given to us eternal life.
Ons dierbare Here, ons dankie baie nederig uit die diepte van ons hart vir hierdie lewende hoop wat ons het in hierdie sterwende lichaam, dat daar een Here God is in Jesus Christus. En deur sy genade en sy goedheid, het hy vir ons die ewige lewe gegee.
And that great hope is in us today, and we feel it as a well bubbling up in our souls, giving us the assurance that all God's words are true.
En daardie groot hoop is in ons vandag, en ons voel dit as 'n fontein wat opborrel in ons siele, wat ons die versekering gee dat al God se woorde waar is.
And so glad to know today that we do not have to just guess about it. It is no more a guess. It is a know-so. For we have read His promise and see Him come and fulfill that promise to the Word. Therefore we know that it is true. And we're grateful for the Holy Ghost, who is a witness of His resurrection.
En so bly om te weet vandag dat ons nie net hoef te raai daaroor nie. Dis nie meer 'n raaiskoot nie, dis 'n wete. Want ons het sy belofte gelees en hom sien kom en daardie belofte van die woord vervul. Daarom weet ons dat dit waar is en ons is dankbaar vir die Heilige Gees wat 'n bewys is van sy opstanding.
And we're grateful for ministers, true prophets of God, who stand for truth and for righteousness. And we pray that you will bless those people today, wherever they may be in their pulpits over the world, that the Holy Spirit will move upon them in power and give them thy word, and may it bring forth great results everywhere. For we believe that the coming of Jesus is at hand.
En ons is dankbaar vir predikers, ware profete van God, wat staan vir die waarheid en vir geregtigheid. En ons bid dat U hierdie mense sal seën vandag, waar hulle ook al mag wees in hulle preekstoele reg oor die wêreld, dat die Heilige Gees oor hulle sal beweeg in krag, en gee hulle U woord, en mag dit oral groot resultate oplewer, want ons glo die koms van Jesus is op hande.
We would ask that you would bless this little church today, its pastor and deacons and all the board and the members and the strangers that's gathered in our gates.
Ons wil vra dat u vandag hierdie kerkie sal seën, sy pastoor en die jakens en die hele raad en die lidmate en die vreemdelinge wat vergader is binne ons poorte.
We are grateful for fellowship, hearing someone say they had drove many miles to come for the service. And truly the scripture is made manifest when it said, if I be lifted up, I'll draw all men unto me.
Ons is dankbaar vir gemeenskap. Iemand hoor sê dat hulle baie mile gery het om na die diens te kom. En waarlik word die skrif gemanifesteer toe dit gesê het, as ek verhoog word, sal ek almal na my toe trek.
We know, Lord, that thy church is not in the majority this morning. The true believers are in the minority. But someday, Lord, you will take that minority to yourself. That's the hour that we long for.
En ons weet, Here, dat U kerk nie in die meerderheid is van môre nie. Die ware gelowiges is in die minderheid. Maar eendag, Here, sal U daardie minderheid na U toe neem. Dis die uur waarvoor ons wag.
That's the day we're waiting to dawn, when we shall see Him who was wounded for our transgressions and was bruised for our iniquity, and the chastisement of our peace upon Him, and with His stripes we were healed. How we thank Thee for this.
Dis die dag waarop ons wag om te breek, wanneer ons hom sal sien, wat deurboor is terwille van ons oortredinge en verbrysel is terwille van ons ongeregtighede, en die straf wat vir ons die vrede aanbring op hom was, en deur sy wonde daar vir ons genesing gekom het. Hoe dank ons U hiervoor.
Praying, Lord, that you will bless your unworthy servant as I try to minister to your people. give them something that would bring all of us closer to Thee. May we leave from this building this morning a better Christian than we was when we come in.
Bid, Here, dat U onwaardige dienstknecht zal zien soos ek probeer preek vir U mense. Geef vir hulle iets wat ons allemaal nader aan U sal bring. Mag ons vanmorgen hierdie gebouw een beter Christen verlaat as wat ons was toe ons ingekom het.
And may, if there be one here who isn't right, Lord, may they leave the building this morning with a happy heart, rejoicing because they have found that pearl of great price that overweight all the rest of the things of their life.
En mag, as daar een hier is wat nie reg is nie, Here, mag hulle die gebouw verlaat vanmorgen met een gelukkige hart, verheug omdat hulle daar die kostbare perel gevind het, wat meer gewig gedra het as al die rest van die dinge van hulle lewe.
We'd ask also, Lord, for those who are sick and afflicted, may they not have to wait for a special service tonight, but may the great Holy Spirit touch that person this morning. Give unto them thy grace.
Ons wil ook vraag, Here, vir diegene wat siek en beproef is, mag hulle nie hoef te wacht vir een speciale dienst vanavond nie, maar mag die groot Heilige Geest daar die persoon van morgen aanraak. Skenk hulle U genade.
Privilege looking up on a woman a few days ago who met us and said, oh, Brother Branham, it seems that a dreadful disease that you cursed one time in the name of the Lord is trying to return again, but I'm resting solemnly up on the thus saith the Lord. And when the physicians had examined our sister Bruce, they found her negative.
Bevoorig om te kyk na 'n vrou wat ons 'n paar dae gelede ontmoet het en gesê het, o, broer Branham, dit lyk asof 'n verskriklike siekte wat jy een keer vervloek het in die naam van die Here weer probeer terugkom. Maar ek rus plegtig op so spreek die Here. En toe die geneesheer ons sister Bruce ondersoek het, het hulle haar negatief bevind.
We are grateful, Lord, that you keep your word. Your promise is so true. May it be a thus saith the Lord this morning for every need that we have need of.
Ons is dankbaar, Here, dat U woord hou. U belofte is so waar. Mag dit is so spreek die Here wees vanmorgen vir elke behoefte wat ons nodig het.
We would remember those who are in the hospital and at home, and especially our brother Rogers. May thy grace and mercy, if it so pleases thee, Lord, speak this morning in a vision and show us just what to tell our brother.
Ons wil diegene wat in die hospitaal is op by die huis en vir al ons broer Rogers onhou. Mag u genade en barmhartigheid, as dit u so behaag, Here, vanmorgen in 'n visioen spreek en net vir ons wys wat om vir ons broer te sê.
For we are your people waiting to hear your word. Until we hear, we'll be trusting every moment. Pour out thy blessings upon all. Bless the reading of the word, and we'll give thee all the praise and all the glory, for we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Ons is u mense wat wacht om u woord te hoor. Tot ons hoor sal ons elke oomblik vertrou. Stort u seëninge uit op almal. Seën die lees van die woord. En ons sal u al die lof en al die eer gee, want ons vra dit in Jesus' naam. Amen.
I wish you all to turn to the 21st chapter of St. Matthew's, if you will. And we're going to read a portion of the Word. Beginning with the first verse.
Ek wil hê julle moet allemaal blaai na die 21ste hoofstuk van Matteus as julle sal. En ons gaan 'n gedeelte van die woord lees vanaf die eerste vers.
And when they drew nigh unto Jerusalem, there came to Bethphage, unto the Mount of Olives, then sent Jesus two disciples, saying unto them, Go ye unto the village over against you, and straightway you shall find an ass tied and a colt with her. Loose them and bring them unto me.
En toen hulle na bij Jerusalem gekom en daar gekom het bij Bethphage, aan die Olijfberg, stuur Jezus twee disciples uit en sê vir hulle, Ga naar daar die dorp recht voor julle en dadelijk zal julle eeselin vind wat vastgemaakt is, en een vol bij haar. Maak hulle los en bring hulle vir my.
And if any man say aught unto you, you shall say the Lord has need of them. And straightway he will send them. All this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the prophet, saying, Tell ye the daughter of Zion, Behold, thy king cometh unto thee meek, setting upon an ass and a colt the foal of an ass.
En as iemand vir julle iets sê, moet julle antwoord, die Here het hulle nodig, en dadelijk sal hy hulle stuur. En dit het alles gebeur, sodat vervul sal word die woord wat deur die profeet gespreek is. Sê vir die dogter van Sion, kyk, jou koning kom na jou toe sagmoedig. Hy sit op 'n esel, ja, jong esel, die vol van 'n pak dier.
And the disciples went and did as Jesus commanded them, and brought the ass and the colt, and put on them their clothes, and set him thereupon. And a very great multitude spread their garments in the ways, and others cut down branches from the trees and strode them in the way.
En de disciples het gegaan en gedoen soos Jesus hulle beveel het. Hulle die esel en die vol gebring en hulle kleren daarop gelê. Hy het daarop op dit gaan sit. En die grootste deel van die skare het hulle klere op die paaie oopgegooi en andere het takke van die bome afgekap en op die pad gestrooi.
And the multitude that went before and that followed cried saying, Hosanna to the Son of David, blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
En die skare het voorgeloop en die wat gevolg het, het uitgeroep en gesê, Hosanna vir die seun van David. Geseën is hy wat kom in die naam van die Here. Hosanna in die hoogste hemel.
And when he was coming to Jerusalem, all the city was moved, saying, Who is this? And the multitude said, This is Jesus, the prophet of Galilee.
En toe hy in Jerusalem inkom, het die hele stad in opskudding geraak gesê, Wie is hier die man? En die skare sê, Dit is Jesus, die profeet van Nas in Galilea.
I want to read or take for a subject this morning them last three words of the 10th verse. Who is this? And may the Lord add his blessings to the reading of his word.
Ek wil lees of vir 'n teks neem van môre daar die laaste drie woorde van die 10de vers. Wie is hierdie? En mag die Here sy seëning voeg by die lees van sy woord.
It must have been about 10 o'clock. On Friday morning, and the people had been up since daylight, moving around in the city.
Dit moes gewees het omtrent 10:00 vrijdagochtend. En die mense was op van daglig af in die stad rondbeweeg.
It was so filled at the time to the, they were sleeping outside the city walls. On the ground, in their tents, anywhere they could find a place to lay down, because this special occasion had drawn people from all over the known world.
Dit was so vol op die tyd, tot die, hulle het buiten die stadsmure geslaap op die grond in hulle tente, enige plek waar hulle plek kon kry om te lê. Wanneer die speciale geleend het, het mense van oral oor die bekende wêreld getrek.
It was called the Feast of the Passover, which had been ordained of God to the Jews way in the early ages of their history. It was where the sacrificial lamb was to be killed and the atonement made for the sins of the people.
Dit was die feest van die Pascha genoem wat ingestel is deur God vir die Jode ver in die vroeë eeue van hulle geskiedenis. Dit was waar die offerlam doodgemaak moes word en die persoening gemaak moes word vir die sondes van die mense.
And this being annually every year it taken place, but this time was a special occasion. There was something a little different going to be about this one.
En hierdie wat jaarliks was, dit het elke jaar plaasgevind. Maar hierdie keer was 'n spesiale geleentheid. Daar was iets wat 'n bietjie anders sou wees aan hierdie een.
You know, and usually where we have services, we have our regular service and our do our worship and pay our tithings and gather in our churches and fellowship with our people. But you know, when Jesus comes, it's always something special.
Amen. Amen.
There's just something we can tell.
Julle weet, in gewoonlik waar ons dienste het, het ons ons gewone diens en ons doen ons aanbidding en betaal ons tiendes en vergader in ons kerk en hou gemeenskap met ons mense. Maar julle weet, wanneer Jesus kom, is dit altyd iets spesiaals. Daar's net iets wat ons weet.
There was great expectations. The air seemed to be charged with something. That would almost parallel the time now. The air is charged today with the expectations of his second coming.
Daar was groot verwagtinge, die lig was skynbaar gelaai met iets. Dit sou amper nou ooreenstem met die tyd, die lig is gelaai vandag met die verwagtinge van sy tweede koms.
There are many in the city then that know nothing about it, just as there is in the world today. And they were many, if they heard, they would care a little about it.
Daar was toe baie in die stad wat niks daarvan geweet het nie, net soos wat daar in die wêreld is vandag. En daar was baie, as hulle gehoor het, hulle min daarvoor sou omgee.
And that's the way it is in the world today, because other things are more fascinating than to men and women of the world than the eternal destination of their soul.
En dis hoe dit is in die wêreld vandag. Want ander dinge is meer fascinerend as die vir mans en vrou van die wêreld, as die ewige bestemming van hulle siel.
But there was some who believed on him. They were expecting him to come and knowing that something special would be there. Something was going to take place.
Maar daar was sommige wat in hom geglo het en hulle het verwag dat hy sou kom. En het geweet dat daar iets spesiaals sou wees, iets sou gebeur.
For Jesus cannot come at any time unless something special does take place. There's always something new when he appears. And they were charged with expectations.
Want Jesus kan nie op enige tydstip kom dat iets spesiaals nie gebeur nie. Altyd iets niets wanneer hy verskyn. En hulle was gelaai met afwagtinge.
But the bad thing about all this There was many who didn't see him, never did get to see him when he come. That's one of the sad things about today. There'll be many who won't see him when he comes.
Maar die slechte ding van het alles, daar was baie wat om nie gesien het nie, om nooit gesien het, toe hy gekom het nie. En dis een van die hartseer dinge van vandag. Daar sal baie wees wat om nie sal sien, wanneer hy kom nie.
But there'll be a remnant.
Amen.
There'll be those who know God and who are waiting and who are charged. They'll see him. For he'll come as a thief in the night. We'll be caught up to meet the Lord in the air, secret going away of the church.
Maar daar sal 'n oorblyfsel wees. Daar sal hulle wees wat God ken en wat wag en wat gelaai is. Hulle sal hom sien, want hy sal kom soos 'n dief in die nag, ons sal weggeraap word, die Here tegemoet in die lig, geheimsinnige vertrek van die kerk.
Oh, I tell you, knowing all this beforehand by the word of the Lord, we should pray and study every hour of our life, making ready for that great event.
O, ek sê julle, deur dit alles te weet voor die tyd, deur die woord van die Here behoort ons elke uur van ons lewe te bid, en te bestudeer, gereed te maak vir haar die groot gebeurtenis.
Now, while the air is charged with His presence, and while we are believing and the anointed ministers of the gospel are sending out the thunderbolts of warning, we should be prepared for any minute for that blessed event when we shall see all that has died in Christ through the ages. When we will see Jesus coming to get his church, then we'll be caught up to meet him in the air.
En terwijl die lig gelaai is met sy teenwoordigheid, en terwijl ons glo in die gesalfde predikers van die evangelie die donderslae van waarskuwing uitstuur, behoort ons voorbereid te wees vir enige minuut, vir haar die kostbare oomblik wanneer ons allemaal sal sien wat gesterf het in Christus deur die eeuwe. Wanneer ons Jesus sien kom om sy kerk te kom haal, dan sal ons weggeraap word om hom te ontmoet in die lig.
There were many who didn't see him that day. And while they were waiting, I suppose, since the break of day, the little congregations gathered from place to place through the city. And they were discussing, saying, I wonder if he will be here at the Passover.
Daar was soveel wat hom nie daardie dag gesien het nie. En terwijl hulle gewag het, veronderstel ek van dagbreek af, het die gemeentetjies van plek tot plek deur die stad by mekaar gekom en hulle het bespreek en gesê, ek wonder of hy hier sal wees by die Pasga.
I can hear a truthful old minister get up and say, yes, congregation, we can look for him because he is the Lamb.
Ek kan een getrouwe prediker hoor opstaan en sê, ja gemeente, ons soek na hom, want hy is die Lam.
Someone inspired by the Holy Spirit who knew God and knew his scriptures and knew the fulfilling of his word was at hand.
Amen.
He'll be here without a shadow of doubt, for he is the Passover Lamb.
Iemand geïnspireerd die Heilige Gees wat vir God geken het en sy skrifte geken het en geweet het dat die vervulling van sy woord op hande was. Hy sal hier wees sonder enige twyfel, want hy is die Pasgalam.
Then you can imagine when this congregation gathered with the little congregation by the gate, and after a while they said he might come through this gate or he might come through that gate. But it didn't make any difference what gate he come through. There's going to see him anyhow because it was a promise.
Amen.
Dan kan jylle jylle voorstel hoe hier die gemeente saam met die klein gemeentekie vergader het by die poort. Hulle nader aan gesê het, hy mag dier haar die poort kom of hy mag dier haar die poort kom. Maar dit het nie enige verskil gemaakt dier wat het poort hy gekom het nie. Hulle sal hom in elk geval sien, want dit was sy belofte.
Whether he comes today in a cloud or on a horse, It makes no difference to me how he comes. We'll see him anyhow, for it's a promise God gave.
O, hij vandag kom in een wolk of op een per, dit maakt voor mij geen verschil hoe hij kom nie. Ons zal hem in elk geval zien, want dit is een belofte wat God gegeet.
And they were waiting with anticipation. The ceremonies were getting ready to start at the temple. The water was already pouring from the rock where the congregation was coming into worship.
En hulle het met afwachting gewacht. Die ceremonies was gereed om te begin by die tempel. Die water het al reeds uit die rots gevloei waar die gemeente ingekom het om te aanbid.
The priest had on their long garments and all their ceremonial garb. Each congregation had gathered in its fitted place. The Pharisees in their corner and the Sadducees in their corner.
Die priesters het hulle lang kleren aangehad en hulle ceremoniële drag. Elke gemeente het op sy geskikte plek vergader. Die Fariseërs in hulle hoek en die Sadduceërs in hulle hoek.
If that is the picture of today, I don't know it. The Methodists in one corner, the Baptists in another corner, the Presbyterians in another corner.
Was dit nie die prentjie van vandag nie, dan weet ek dit nie. Die Methodists in een hoek, die Baptists in die ander hoek, die Presbyterians in die ander hoek.
But somewhere scattered among them in little groups is the church of the living God. Amen. Not paying attention to ceremonies, but waiting for his appearing.
Amen.
Waiting for that blessed moment.
Maar iewers versprei onder hulle almal in groepies is die kerk van die lewende God, wat nie steer aan ceremonies nie, maar wacht vir sy beskyning, wacht vir haar die kostbare oomblik.
While the rest of them is just interested in the ceremony, the feast of the tabernacles and the religious rituals. But the Spirit of God has charged our hearts that we know he's coming soon.
Amen.
Terwyl die rest van hulle net geïnteresseerd is in hulle die ceremony, die hittefeest en die godsdienstige rituele. Maar die Geest van God het ons harte gelaai dat ons weet hy kom binnenkort.
And as they were waiting, all of a sudden, from the top of the hill, come a little congregation moving down.
Amen.
One sitting on a little white mule, coming slowly towards the gate.
En terwijl hulle gewag het, het daar met eens een klein gemeentekie van boe van die heuwel af, ondertoe beweeg, een wat op een wit muilkie gesit het, wat stadig na die poort toe aankom.
The people begin to scream, breaking the branches off the trees and throwing their garments in the road, hollering, Hosanna to him that cometh in the name of the Lord.
Die mense het begin skree, die takke van die bome afgebreek en hulle kleer in die pad gegooi geskree, Hosanna aan hom wat kom in die naam van die Here.
And as the little mule moved forward, fulfilling the scriptures of the prophet said, O daughter of Zion, see what it was a church, the elect. Your Lord cometh to you, meek and lowly, setting upon a little mule riding.
En soos die muilkie voor en te beweeg die skrifte van die profeet vervul het, wat gesê het, O dochter van Sion, sien wat het was, dit was die kerk die uitverkoren is. Jou Heere kom na jou toe sagmoedig en nederig, wat op een muilkie sit en ry.
And today, while the church is waiting, one of these days coming down from the skies, he'll come riding on a white horse. You notice that white's always represented?
En vandag, terwyl die kerk wag, sal daar een van hier die dag uit die lucht kom, hy wat op een wit perd ry. Let julle op, dat wit altyd verteenwoordig word.
The little white mule, he came as a foreshadow of coming riding on the charger with his vesture dipped in blood. A name on him called the Word of God. That's his coming now.
Die klein wit muilkie, hy gekom het, was een voorafskaduwing van die komst aan die rij op die perd met sy kleren gedroop in bloed, een naam op hom wat genoem word, die Woord van God, dis nou sy koms.
The little groups have gathered watching, waiting for that appearing. And what a rejoicing it will be when we go forward, breaking off the branches, screaming, Hosanna to him that cometh in the name of the Lord.
Die groep is het versameld, opgehouden, wacht voor haar verschijning. En wat er gejeeg zal dit wees, wanneer ons voor toe gaan, die takken afbreken en schreeuwen, Hosanna om, wat kom in die naam van de Heere.
It is gives such a stir among the people. The Methodists and the Baptists of that day, the Sadducees and the Pharisees and the different ones, until they said, who is this coming?
Amen.
What's all this disturbance about?
Dat het zo'n opschudding veroorzaakt onder die mensen, die Methodisten, die Baptisten van haar die dag, die Sadduceers en Pharisees en verschillendes, dat hulle gezegd, wie is hier die wat daar komt? Waaroor gaan al hier die frustrering?
We see nothing so alarmed about it. There's just a man. And he's riding on a little mule. There's nothing to be alarmed about. Why all the fuss and the carrying on? Who is it?
Ons sien niks so opwinder daaraan nie. Daar is net 'n man en hy ry op 'n muiltjie. Daar is niks om oor ontstel te raak nie. Waarom al die opheffen aangaan, Rie? Wie is dit?
Just before the coming of the Lord Jesus, he sent the Holy Ghost to the church in this last day.
Amen.
And the Holy Ghost has been a witness of his resurrection.
Amen.
And has proved that he lives.
Amen. Right.
And he is coming. And the
Amen.
Church getting itself ready.
Amen.
Net voor de komst van de Heere Jesus het hy die Heilige Geest naar de kerk toe gestuur in hierdie laatste dag. En de Heilige Geest was een getuie van zijn opstanding en bewees dat hij leven. En hij kom in de kerk wat het zelf gereed maakt.
And as we see the church making itself ready, abstaining from fornications, abstaining from idolatry, abstaining from lasciviousness, and all the works of the flesh.
En soos ons die kerk dit self sien gereed maak, wegbleef van onsbandigheid, wegbleef van afgodedienst, wegbleef van ontuchtigheid en al die werken van die vlees.
We, the church and the peoples, see the little congregations getting together, stopping their drinking, stopping their lying, stopping their tattling, stopping everything that's of the flesh, making themselves ready, screaming to the top of their voices and clapping their hands and shouting the victory.
Ons die kerk en die mense sien die klein gemeentekies vergader, wat op hom met hulle drinkry, op hom met hulle leens, op hom met hulle geskinder, op hom met alles wat van die vlees is, hulle self gereed maak, wat so hard skree as wat hulle kan, en hulle hande klap en die oorwinning skree.
The people's crowd, who is this? They don't understand. They didn't understand then.
Amen.
He come meek and lowly. Came riding on a mule, and he come today to the poor and the afflicted.
Die mense roep uit, wie is hierdie? Hulle verstaan nie. Hulle het nie toe verstaan nie. Hy het gekom sagmoedig en nederig, aangery gekom op 'n muil, en hy kom vandag na die armes en die beproefdes toe.
For the rest of them say there's no such a thing as healing. There's no such a thing as the baptism of the Holy Spirit. It's all a bunch of nonsense. There's nothing to it. But just the same, he come. Proving his resurrection.
Maar die rest van hulle sê, daar is glad nie so iets soos genesing nie. Daar is glad nie so iets soos die doop van die Heilige Gees nie. Dis alles 'n klomp onsin, daar is niks daaraan nie. Maar hy kom in elk geval, bewys sy opstanding.
Every sign that he did on earth, he's doing it right now in the form of the Holy Ghost. There's an expectation amongst the people. They're waiting for that great event of his soon approach.
Elke teken wat hy op die aarde gedoen het, dit doen hy nou ook in die vorm van die Heilige Gees. Daar's 'n verwagting onder die mense. Hulle wag vir daardie groot gebeurtenis van sy spoedige naderkoms.
We know it won't be long until we shall see him. Who we've loved And we believe that it won't be too long now until all things that was prophesied in the scriptures will be fulfilled.
Ons weet dat zal niet lang wees voor ons om zal zien voor wie ons lief gaat het niet. En ons glo dat het nou niet meer lang zal wees voordat alle dingen wat geprofeteerd in die schriften vervuld zal worden.
Now in that congregation in that day, there was a divided opinion. Some of them cried, "Who is it? What's causing all this racket? Why is that bunch of Galileans, holy rulers, screaming and carrying on like that?"
Nou, in daar gemeente na die dag, was daar een verdeelde opinie. Want hy vir hulle het uitgeroep, "Wie is dit? Wat veroorzaak al daar die geraas? Hoekom skree en gaan daar die klomp Galileërs, holy rollers, so te keer?"
I can see one good old disciple walk up and say, "Don't you know, brethren? That's the prophet of Galilee. That's Jesus of Nazareth.
Amen.
That was spoken of by the scriptures."
Ek kan een goeie ou disipel sien nader stap sê, "Weet julle nie, broers, dis die profeet van Galilee. Dis Jesus van Nazareth, waarvan gepraat is in die skrifte."
"Don't you know the scripture says he shall come riding upon the foal of an ass, and he will come into his people."
Amen.
"And that's the reason that they're carrying on the way they are."
Amen.
"Weet julle nie die skrif sê hy sal aangery kom op die foal van 'n esel nie? En hy sal na sy volk kom, en dis hoekom hulle so aangaan."
We have been in the meetings of this man. We have seen him raise the dead. We've seen him open the eyes of the blind. We have seen him stand there and look out over his congregation and why reason ye in your heart?
Amen.
We have seen him do great signs and we know that's the Messiah.
Ons was in haar die manse dienste. Ons het hom die dooie sien opwek. Ons het hom die oe van die blinde sien opmaak. Ons het hom daar sien staan en oor sy gemeente kyk en hoekom redeneer jylle in jylle hart? Ons het om groot tekens sien doen, ons weet dis die Messias.
They were mixed multitude. Some said, "Well, it might be that he could be such a thing." Now, isn't that just the way they feel today?
Amen.
Hulle was 'n gemengde skare. Party het gesê, "Wel, dit mag wees dat hy so iets kon wees." Nou is dit nie net hoe hulle vandag voel nie.
What's all this about? Is there such a thing as the Holy Spirit? What makes those people act the way they do?
Waaroor gaan dit alles? Is daar so iets soos die Heilige Gees? Wat laat daardie mense so optree?
Why, it's a foretaste of glory divine.
Amen.
It's a power. It's the Holy Spirit that's here on earth representing Christ, just a shadow of his coming. All these things as prophesied would take place just before he come again.
Amen.
And we know it. That's why we're excited about it.
Amen.
That's why we're enthused about it.
Ja, dis 'n voorsmaak van goddelike heerlikheid. Dis 'n krag. Dis die Heilige Gees wat hier op die aarde is, wat Christus verteenwoordig, net 'n skaduwee van sy koms. Al hierdie dinge is geprofeteer wat sou plaasvind net voor hy weer gekom het. En ons weet dit, dis hoekom ons opgewonde is daaroor. Dis hoekom ons geesdriftig is daaroor.
Makes any difference what the other people say? That doesn't matter a bit. The people say today, "Who is that?"
Maak geen verskil wat die ander mense sê nie, dit maak glad nie saak nie. Die mense sê vandag, "Wie is dit?"
Them day they said, "We don't know who he is, Jesus of Nazareth." Well, we'll go over and look up into the decalogues and we'll find if he belonged to this denomination. We'll find out whether he was either Pharisee or Sadducee or Herodian or whatever he might be. We'll look up.
Daardie dag het hulle gesê, "Ons weet nie wie hy Jesus van Nazareth is nie." Wel, ons sal oorgaan opsoek in die decalogie. En ons sal uitvind of hy aan hierdie denominasie behoort het. Ons sal uitvind of hy 'n Fariseer of Sadduseer of 'n Herodiaan is of wat hy ook al mag wees. Ons sal opsoek.
And they could find no record of his schooling, of any degree that he had. And then they come back again, who is he?
En hulle kon geen record van sy opleiding vind van enige graad wat hy gehad het nie. En toe het hulle weer teruggekom. Wie is hy?
He doesn't belong to any of our traditions. He isn't connected with any of our, he isn't affiliated with any of our affiliations. He has no degrees.
Hy behoort nie aan enige van ons tradities nie. Hy is nie verbind met enige van ons. Hy is nie geaffilieer met enige van ons affiliaties nie. Hy het geen grade nie.
We have no record of him going to school. He never was in a seminary. He isn't neither claimed on these books or them books. We don't see him anywhere. Who is he?
Ons het geen record daar hy skool toe is nie. Hy was nooit in 'n skool nie. Hy is ook nie genoem op hierdie boeke of daardie boeke nie. Ons sien hom nêrens. Wie is hy?
His own credentials was the works that God gave him to do.
Amen.
He said, if I do not the works of God, then don't believe me.
Sy eie geloofsbrief was die werke wat God vir hom gegee het om te doen. Hy het gesê, as ek nie die werke van God doen nie, moet my dan nie glo nie.
They had their own way of believing, by a man's credentials, by the denomination he belonged to, just as it is today. He's known by his denominational credentials.
Hulle het hulle eie manier van glo gehad deur 'n man se geloofsbriewe, deur die denominasie waarin hy behoort het, net soos dit vandag is, hy word erken aan sy denominationele geloofsbriewe.
But a man of God, the Holy Spirit that's among the people, gets on to people, gets on to the minister, gets on to the congregation. It identifies what it is, not by denomination, but by the power of the resurrection of Jesus Christ, foreshadowing his coming.
Maar een man van God, die Heilige Geest wat onder die mensen is, kom op die mensen, kom op die prediker, kom op die gemeente, en identificeer wat het is, niet door de denominatie nie, maar door de kracht van de opstanding van Jesus Christus, wat zijn komst vooraf skadu.
Oh, what an hour that we live in. Palms and hands, clothing on the back, ready to show in the way. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord.
O, wat een uur waarin ons leven, palms in die handen, kleren aan die lijf gereed om in die pad te gooien. Geseen is hij wat kom in die naam van die Heere.
What come in the name of the Lord, the Holy Spirit? When he comes, he'll show you things to come. He will not speak of himself, but he'll speak of me, said Jesus.
Wat kom in die naam van die Heere, die Heilige Geest, wanneer ik kom, zal hij voor julle dingen wees wat zal komen. Hij zal niet van homself spreek nie, maar hij zal van mij spreken, het Jesus gesê.
And the Holy Spirit comes to do its work in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
All the way from the pulpit to the baptismal pool to the healing service to everywhere else, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Watching for the coming of the Lord, preparing a church as a forerunner as John the Baptist, forerun the first coming. The Holy Spirit is in the church forerunning, getting a church ready for the second coming.
En die Heilige Gees kom om sy werk te doen in die naam van die Here Jesus. Die hulppad van die preekstoel naar die doopbad, naar die genesingsdienst, naar oral. In die naam van Jesus Christus. Dop over die komst van die Here. Kerk voorbereid as 'n voorloper. Soos Johannes die Doper die eerste komst vooraf gegaan het, is die Heilige Geest in die kerk om vooraf te gaan, 'n kerk gereed te kry vir die tweede komst.
And the world cries out, who is this? Where did they come from? What credentials have they? What schools do they come from?
En die wereld roep uit, wie is hier die? Waar het hulle vandaan gekom? Watter geloofsbriewe het hulle? Uit watter skole kom hulle?
You don't find them on the record. It's in glory.
Amen.
Where they come from.
Amen.
And heaven's where their records are. For their kingdom is not of this world, but it's of the world that is to come.
Jy vind hulle nie op die record nie. Dis in heerlikheid waar hulle vandaan kom. En die hemel is waar hulle records is. want hulle koninkryk is nie van hierdie wêreld nie, maar dis van die wêreld wat sal kom.
Their desire is not of this world, it's of the world that is to come. Their passions, their desires, that's the reason the dressing and the acting and the habits of the people of the world is so contrary.
Hulle begeerte is nie van hierdie wêreld nie. Dis van die wêreld wat sal kom, hulle modes, hulle begeertes. Dis hoekom die klere dag en die optrede en die gewoontes van die mense van die wêreld so teenstrydig is.
You'll usually do like the spirit that's in you. It motivates your life. It makes you what you are. Is the life that's in you.
Jy sal gewoonlik maak soos die gees wat in jou is. Dit motiveer jou lewe. Dit maak jou wat jy is. Is die lewe wat in jou is.
And when men and women claim to be Christians and still want to be like the world, there's something wrong somewhere. For we are not of this world.
En wanneer mans en vroue wat aanspraak maak om Christene te wees, en steeds soos die wêreld wil wees, is daar iewers iets verkeerd, want ons is nie van hierdie wêreld nie.
For our spirit, if we were Germans, we'd like Germany. If we were Finland, we'd do as they do in Finland. If they're Americans, they have the American spirit.
Want ons gees, as ons Duitsers is, is ons soos Duitsland. As ons Finland was, sal ons maak soos Finland maak. As hulle Amerikaners is, het hulle Amerikaanse gees.
If we're Christians, we have a heavenly spirit. And our spirits come from above that directs our lives and our thoughts. That's godly, brotherly love. Clean life. Honorable. Respected peoples.
As ons Christen is, het ons 'n hemelse gees. En ons geeste kom van bo. Dit rig ons lewens en gedagtes. Dis goddelik. Broederlike liefde, skoon lewe, eerbaar gerespekteerde mense.
Now, in there they said, some was for him, some was against him. Now there is people today who firmly is against everything that's called God. No religion. And they're mostly in the majority in our country.
Nou daarin het hulle gesê, sommige was vir hom, en sommige was teen hom. Nou daar is mense vandag wat streng teen alles is wat God genoem word. Geen godsdienst nie. En hulle is meestal in die meerderheid in ons land.
World over there, far in the majority. Millions and millions has never heard the name of Jesus Christ. They are in the majority.
Wereld oor is een ver in die meerderheid. Miljoene en miljoene wat nooit die naam van Jesus Christus gehoor het nie. Hulle is in die meerderheid.
Then there are those who are professors of religion. And they love to put on their ceremonies. They love to be dignitaries.
Dan is daar diegene wat beleiers van godsdienst is. En hulle hou daarvan om hulle ceremonies te hou. Hulle hou daarvan om hooggeplaases te wees.
They like to dress and to go to the church and to have some kind of a hymns and a little message of some sort. Talk of a God that was and then place him so far back in history that he can't move. That he was something it was.
Hulle hou daarvan om aan te trek en om kerk toe te gaan en een of ander soort gesange te hê en 'n boodskapie van 'n aard te praat oor 'n God wat was. En om dan so ver terug in die geskiedenis plaas dat hy nie kan beweeg nie. Dat hy iets was wat was.
They want to claim that Jesus is right. He was a good fellow. He was a great man. He was like Washington, never told a lie. Or like Napoleon. That's their attitude about Jesus.
Hulle wil aanspraak maak dat Jesus is reg. Hy was 'n goeie kerel. Hy was 'n groot man. Hy was soos Washington, het nooit 'n leuen vertel nie. Of soos Napoleon. Dis hulle gesindheid teenoor Jesus.
They think that he was just a good man. Many of them today don't claim him to be divine.
Amen.
They just claim that he was a good man. That his teaching was right. Some of them believe him just to be a prophet.
Hulle dink dat hy net 'n goeie man was. Baie van hulle vandag sê nie dat hy goddelik was nie. Hulle sê net dat hy 'n goeie man was, dat sy leringe reg was, party van hulle glo dat hy net 'n profeet was.
But there is those who go beyond that boundary. I believe him to be God. Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today and forever. That he wasn't just a prophet. That he wasn't just a man. That he wasn't just a teacher or a good man. He was the divine Jehovah God living in a body of flesh.
Maar daar is diegene wat oor daardie grenslyn gaan. Ek glo dat hy God is. Jesus Christus dieselfde gister, vandag tot in ewigheid. Dat hy nie net 'n profeet was nie, dat hy nie net 'n mens was nie, dat hy nie net 'n leraar was of 'n goeie man nie. Hy was die goddelike Jehovah God wat in 'n liggaam van vlees gewoon het.
You ask me who is this? That's what my opinion of him is. He's God manifested in the flesh to take away the sins of the world.
Jy moet so vra, wie is hierdie? Dis wat my opinie van hom is. Hy is God gemanifesteer in die vlees om die sonde van die wêreld weg te neem.
Who is this? Not just a man, not just a prophet, but the Emmanuel, God with us. Then not only with us, but in us.
Amen.
Through us. God in the midst of us.
Wie is hierdie? Nie net 'n mens nie, nie net 'n profeet nie, maar die Emmanuel, God met ons. Dan nie net met ons nie, maar in ons, deur ons, God in ons midde.
Then if that is true, a supernatural God cannot change his nature.
Amen.
To fit people's nature.
Amen.
People has to change their nature.
Amen.
To fit God's supernatural plans. That's why people cry, who is this? It's God in the midst of his people. They don't understand it.
Dan as dit waar is, 'n bonatuurlike God kan nie sy natuur verander om by mense se natuur te pas nie. Mense moet hulle natuur verander om by God se bonatuurlike planne te pas. Dis hoekom mense uitroep, wie is hierdie? Dis God in sy mense se midde. Hulle verstaan dit nie.
God will never come to your level. You'll have to come to his. God will not come to your requirement. You have to come to God's.
God sal nooit op jou vlak kom nie. Jy moet op syne kom. God sal nie jou vereiste nakom nie. Jy moet God se nakom.
And then when that requirement is met upon a promise that God made to redeem the people. If that requirement has met, your entire being changes.
Amen.
Your thinking changes. Your habits change. Everything about you changes.
En dan wanneer daardie vereiste nagekom is oor 'n belofte wat God gemaak het om die mense te verlos. As daardie vereiste nagekom is, verander jou hele wese. Jou denke verander, jou gewoontes verander. Alles omtrent jou verander.
Amen.
Your desires change. Your living changes. Your habits change, you change. Everything about you changes. Because there's a new life in you.
Jou begeertes verander. Jou lewenswyse verander. Jou gewoontes verander. Jy verander. Alles omtrent jou verander. Want daar's 'n nuwe lewe in jou.
That's what makes the people today say, who is this? Is this that fellow used to work over here? Is this that? Who is this? Where did he go to school at? What credentials does he pack, says the preachers?
Dis wat die mense vandag laat sê, wie is hierdie? Is dit daardie kerel wat altyd hier oor kan gewerk het? Is dit hierdie? Wie is dit? Waar het hy skool toe gegaan? Watter geloofsbriewe het hy, sê die predikers?
Who is this woman? Is that the woman I used to see out there on the street? Yes, what's the matter with her? Something happened.
Amen.
Waar, wie is hierdie vrou? Is dit nie die vrou wat ek altyd daar op die straat gesien het nie? Ja. Wat maak hier haar? Iets het gebeur.
And this woman used to wear shorts. But something happened. Isn't this the man that used to smoke cigars? But something happened.
Amen.
Isn't this the man that used to drink? But something happened.
Is dit nie die vrou wat altyd kortbroek gedra het nie, maar iets het gebeur? Is dit nie die man wat altyd sigare gerook het nie, maar iets het gebeur? Is dit nie die man wat eers gedrink het nie, maar iets het gebeur?
Isn't this the man and woman used to curse and go to the nightclubs, but they don't do it no more? Who is this?
Amen.
It's the Holy Spirit, the person of God living in them.
Amen.
I'll go down to their churches to find out what's the matter.
Is dit nie die man en vrou wat altyd gevloek het en na nachtklubs toe gegaan het nie? Maar hulle doen dit nie meer nie. Wie is hierdie? Dis die Heilige Gees, die persoon van God wat in hulle woon. Ek sal na hulle kerk toe gaan om uit te vind wat fout is.
Like the Pharisees did. They said, we'll go down to the gate. We'll find out what they say. We'll see who this guy is on this little white mule riding down the hill.
Soos die Fariseërs, hulle het gesê, ons sal afgaan na die poort. Ons sal uitvind wat hulle sê. Ons sal sien wie hierdie kerel is op hierdie wit muiltjie wat teen die hemel afry.
And when they got to the gates, these people really had a time.
Amen.
They screamed and they hollered. They shouted and they praised the Lord.
En toe hulle by die poorte gekom het, het hierdie mense regtige tyd gehad. Hulle het gegil en geskree, hulle het uitgeroep en hulle het die Here geloof.
And it was so contrary to their religion of that day, those priests and rabbis standing around. They said, make them hold their peace. We won't be able to hear what the doctor's going to say or what the reverend. Make them hold their peace.
En dit was so teenstrijdig met hulle godsdienst van daardie dag, daardie priesters en rabbies wat rondgestaan het. En hulle het gesê, laat hulle stil bly. Ons sal nie kan hoor wat die dokter gaan sê of wat die eerwaarde. Laat hulle stil bly.
Jesus, I can see him as he turned. Said if they hold their peace, the rocks will immediately cry out.
Amen.
Something had to happen.
Jesus, ek kan hom sien soos hy omgedraai het gesê, as hulle stil bly, sal die klippe dadelijk uitroep. Iets moes gebeur.
Say, could the rocks cry out? The very God that created them was riding in on them. Why couldn't they make them hold their peace? They couldn't hold their peace.
Say, kan die klippe uitroep die enigste God wat hulle geskaap het, het ingery oor hulle. Hoekom kon hulle nie? Hulle laat stil bly nie. Hulle kon nie stil bly nie.
That's the way today, when the congregation is gathered together, that foreshadow of his appearing. The Holy Spirit begins to breathe upon them. They see those signs and wonders performed of the Holy Spirit. They can't hold their peace.
Amen.
Something's going to cry out.
Dis vir ons vandag wanneer die gemeente vergader is, daar die voorafskaduwing van sy verskyning die Heilige Gees oor hulle begin blaas. Hulle sien daar die tekens en wonder wat gedoen word deur die Heilige Gees. Hulle kan nie stil bly nie, iets gaan uitroep.
And the church world said, who is this? What's this all about? Are you one of them? What caused all of this? They don't get it. And they don't get it today. They didn't get it then. They never will get it.
Amen.
En die kerk wereld het gesê, wie is hierdie? Waaroor gaan dit alles? As jy een van hulle? Wat het dit alles veroorsaak? Hulle begryp dit nie. En hulle begryp dit nie vandag nie. Hulle het dit toen nie begryp nie. Hulle sal dit nooit begryp nie.
The anointing of the Holy Spirit has brought that to the church world. It's brought, see, there's a three classes. The unbeliever, the make-believer, and the real believer.
Amen.
And many times make-believers come in amongst real believers. And they cry, yeah, who is it?
Die salwing van die Heilige Gees het dit na die kerk wereld gebring. Dit is gebring, sien daar die drie klasse. Die ongelovige, skeingelovige en ware gelovige. En baie keer kom skeingeloviges onder ware gelovigis en hulle roep steeds uit, wie is dit?
Who is this that will come into a congregation that will anoint it till one will speak with tongues and another give the interpretation exactly tell a sinner of his sins and where he's at?
Wie is hier die wat in die gehoor sal inkom, wat het sal sal totdat een in tale spreek en ander uitleg sal gee, een sonder precies sal vertel van sy sondes en waar hy is?
Who is this that stands in an illiterate woman that can't read her name? and will stand under the anointing of the Holy Ghost and speak words that she never heard.
Amen.
And a Mexican raise up in the church and say, I understood every word of it.
Amen.
And even call me by the name and call me to repent. God have mercy on my soul.
Amen.
Who is this?
Wie is hierdie wat staan in ongeletterde vrou wat nie haar naam kan lees nie, en sal staan onder die salving van die Heilige Gees en woorde sal spreek wat sy nog nooit gehoor het nie, en een Mexikaan staan op in die kerk en sê, ek het elke woord daarvan verstaan, en my selfs op die naam noem, en my sê om te bekeer, en mag God my siel genadig wees, wie is hierdie?
Who is it can get in a literate farmer? And can stand there the inspiration and tell a man who he is and where he come from and what happened to him, what he must do, what will be his outcome.
Wie is dit wat de ongeletterde boer kan neem en daar kan staan onder die inspiratie voor een man kan sê wie hij is, en waar hij vandaan kom en wat gebeur het met hom, en wat hij moet doen en wat zijn uiteinde zal wees.
The world cries out, who is this? What is this? Where did it come from? It's the Holy Spirit come from God. For what purpose? To prepare a people. Give them a heavenly atmosphere. A desire to come up higher.
Die wereld roep uit, wie is hierdie? Wat is hierdie? Waar het dit vandaan gekom? Dis die Heilige Gees wat van God afkom. Vir wat er doel? Om mense voor te berei. Hulle hemelse atmosfeer te gee. Een begeerte om hoër op te kom.
Now it isn't so much of what other people think that. The thing we're thinking about this morning is who do you think it is? It's up to you and I.
Nou, dit is nie so veel wat ander mense dink, wat nie. Die ding waar ons kan dink vanmorgen is, wie dink jy is dit? Dit hang van my en jou af.
Is it just the fellowship of a denomination called Pentecostal? Church of God, Pilgrim Hall, or Nazarene, or something like that. Church of God, Assemblies of God. United Pentecostal Church, is that what it is? If that's it, you're miserable.
Amen.
That's it, your religion is just a religion. It has no salvation in it.
Is dit net een gemeenskap van die denominatie genaamd Pinksterkerk van God, Pelgrim of Nazareens, of so iets soos daar die kerk van God, gemeentes van God, verenigde Pinksterkerk? Is dit wat het is? As dit is, is jylle ellendig. Dis reg, jylle godsdienst is net een godsdienst, daar is geen verlossing daarin nie.
But if you examined it and found it in your soul to be Jesus Christ, the Son of God,
amen,
then blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Maar as jy dit sal onderzoek en dit gevind het in jou siel om Jesus Christus, die Seun van God in jou siel te wees, dan geseend is hy wat kom in die naam van die Heilige Gees.
Hosanna in the highest!
Amen.
To him that cometh in the Holy Ghost, because it is Jesus Christ's own spirit in his church.
Amen.
Making you sons and daughters of his. Giving you his nature. For you will live with the Father also in the eternal times to come.
Hosanna in die hoogste aan hom wat kom in die Heilige Gees, want dit is Jesus Christus eie gees in sy kerk, wat van julle seuns en dogters van hom maak, vir julle sy natuur gee, want julle sal ook saam lewe by die Vader in die ewige tye wat sal kom.
Who is it? What's this all about? And the coming of the Holy Spirit has always brought such.
Wie is dit? Waaroor gaan dit alles in die komst van die Heilige Gees het altyd sulke dinge gebring?
In the days of Noah, when the Holy Spirit come upon Noah, and he began to prophesy, and began to say that there's coming a time that the world will be destroyed with water. Look how contrary it was to their belief.
In die dag van Noah, toe die Heilige Gees oor Noah gekom het, en hy begin profeteer, het begin het sê, daar sou 'n tyd kom, waar die wereld deur water vernietig sou word. Kyk hoe teenstrijdig was dit met hulle geloof.
There was mockers and scoffers, said the Bible. Making fun, they were eating, drinking, and making merry. Laughed in the face of that prophet. And wondered who was it. They soon found out who it was.
Daar was diegene wat gespot en uitgelach het, en die Bijbel gesê, die spot gedreef het. Hulle het geëet, gedrink, gevijf, gelag in die gezicht van haar profeet en gewonder, wie was dit? Hulle het gauw uitgevind wie dit was.
Every time the Holy Spirit comes, it brings a division amongst the people. It brings a time that man must stand and make a decision. It's come to you, it's come to me. We've got to make our decisions.
Elke keer waar die Heilige Geest komt, brengt dit een verdeeldheid onder die mensen. Dit brengt een tijd waar die mens moet staan en een besluit neem. Dit het naar julle toe gekom, dit het naar mij toe gekom. Ons moet ons besluiten maken.
It come in the days of Noah. It also come in the time of Moses. When God anointed his servant with the Holy Spirit. Sent him down into Egypt. Some said, who is this Superman?
Amen.
Who is this guy that would make himself a ruler over us?
Dit het gekom in die dag van Noah. Dit het ook gekom in die tijd van Moses, toe God sy dienstknecht gesalf het met die Heilige Gees, om afgestuur het naar Egypte. Sommige gesê, wie is hier die Superman? Wie is hier die kerel wat homself een heerser oor ons wil maak?
Amen. Moses didn't desire to be a ruler. He is bringing the people the truth. What does he do? Break up our religions. That's what they said about Jesus. He condemns our religions because that's all they had.
Moses het nie begeer om 'n heerser te wees nie. Hy het die waarheid vir die mense gebring. Wat doen hy? Breek ons godsdienste uit mekaar. Dis wat hulle van Jesus gesê het. Hy veroordeel ons godsdienste. Want dis al wat hulle gehad het.
Same was the days of Noah, or Moses. Moses came down and he tore up their traditions and brought them to a living faith in a living God. And led them from victory to victory with signs and wonders. It stumped the unbelievers.
Dieselfde was in die dag van Noah of Moses. Moses het afgekom. En hy het hulle tradities verbreek en hulle gebring naar de levende geloof van de levende God. En hulle gelei van oorwinning tot oorwinning met tekens en wonders. Dat die ongelooviges verstom.
Who is this? Who is that man? Where is he born at? We thought he was an Egyptian. Here all at once he must be some illegitimate child somewhere. Who is he that comes in this name? It's always been that way.
Wie is hier nie? Wie is daar die man? Waar is hy gebore? Ons het gedink hy was Egyptenaar. Hier met eens, hy moes een of ander buitenechtelike kind iewers gewees het. Wie is hy wat kom in hierdie naam? Dit was nog altyd so.
In the days of Jesus, they said, who is he? He has no education. We have no schools, no record of his schooling. We have no denomination that he belongs to. Who is he?
In die dag van Jesus het hulle gesê, wie is hy? Hy het geen opleiding. Ons het geen school, geen record van sy opleiding. Ons het geen denominatie waarin hy behoort nie. Wie is hy?
Only thing we ever know, there's some crazy man out here, a wild man, by the name of John the Baptist, hair sticking out all over his face and half naked, with a piece of sheepskin wrapped around him, declared his coming, and he was born to illegitimate birth. His mother was to be mother with him before Joseph ever married his mother.
Enigste ding wat ons ooit geweet het, daar was een malman hier buiten, een wilde man met die naam van Johannes die Doper, haar wat oral oor sy gezicht uitsteek en half naak met een stuk skaapvel om hem gedraai, wat sy komst aangekondig het. Hy, en hy is buitenechtelijk gebore, sy ma moes ma word met hom voor Joseph ooit met sy ma getrouwd was.
Who is that? The only record they had of him.
Wie is dit? Dit is die enigste record met hulle van hom gehad het. Geseend sy die naam van die Here.
That's all they know about the church today. Some bunch of posthole diggers or something. No record at all.
Amen.
The record is not kept on earthly books. It's divinely protected in heaven.
Dit is al wat hulle vandag van die kerk weet. Een of ander groot heiningpaal planters of iets. Hoegenaamd geen record nie. Die record wordt niet op aardse boeken gehou nie. Dit wordt goddelijk bewaar in die hemel.
Who is this? This is a drunkard. This was so and so. That's right. But now he's the Son of God.
Amen.
He's been transformed. Who is he? Who is this that comes in the name of the Lord?
Wie is hier die? Hier was een dronklap. Hier was so en so daarie. Dat is recht, maar nou is hij een seun van God, is getransformeerd. Wie is hij? Wie is hier die wat kom in die naam van die Heere?
When the Holy Ghost comes today, it brings the same decisions. Each one of us are responsible for our decision. We must make it. It's here by us. It's here with us. There's no way around it anymore. There's nothing we can do about it. We have to reject it or receive it.
Wanneer de Heilige Geest vandaag komt, brengt het hetzelfde besluit. Elke van ons is verantwoordelijk voor ons besluit. Ons moet het nemen. Dus hier bij ons, dus hier met ons. Daar is geen manier om daar voorbij te komen. Nie. Daar is niks wat ons daarin kan doen. Nie. Ons moet het verwerp of dit ontvang.
The same life that was in Christ Jesus is in the church today. It's performing the same works. It's doing the same miracles. It's doing everything that he did.
Ditzelfde leven wat in Christus Jesus was in die kerk vandaag. Dit doen dezelfde werken, doen dezelfde wonderwerken. Dit doen alles wat hij gedoen het.
It's healing the sick, raising the dead, cleansing the lepers, casting out devils, preaching the gospel. The poor is receiving it.
Amen.
Blessed is he who is not offended.
Amen.
Go show John, he said, these things that are done.
Dit genees die siekes, rig die dooies op, reinig die melaatses, drijf duivels uit, verkondig die evangelie, die armes ontvang dit. Zalig is hy wat nie aanstoot neem, gaan wees vir Johannes, het hy gesê, hier die dinge wat gedoen word.
John in the prison is eagle-eyed, filmed over. His prophetic eye couldn't see like it once seen. But then it could see when he said the lame walk, the blind see, the deaf hear. And blessed is he who is not offended in what I do.
Johannes in die tronk, daar het 'n vlies oor sy arends oog gevorm. Sy profetiese oog kon nie meer sien soos dit eers het nie. Maar toe kon hy sien, toe hy gesê het, die krepers loop, die blinde sien, die doofes hoor, en salig is hy, hy weet nie aan wat ek doen, aanstoot neem nie.
If I do not the works of my Father, then believe me not. And if I do the works of my Father, if you can't believe me, believe the works.
As ek nie die werke van my Vader doen nie, moet my dan nie glo nie. As ek die werke van my Vader doen, as julle my nie kan glo nie, glo die werke.
Now that was his message. That's what he said that it must be done. That's what we've got to do, is to make a decision. What will we do with it? It's here.
Nou dit was sy boodskap. Dis wat hy gesê het, dat het gedoen moes word. Dis wat ons moet doen, is om 'n besluit te maak. Wat sal ons doen daarmee? Dis hier.
Who is it? What is it? It's a promise of God by his word that he'd do it. God promised he would do it. And we see it being done. Now, it's up to us to make a decision. Will we serve? Will we understand?
Wie is dit? Wat is dit? Dis 'n belofte van God in sy woord dat hy dit sou doen. God het beloof hy sou dit doen en ons sien dit gedoen word. Nou de lang van ons af om besluit te maak. Sal ons dien? Sal ons verstaan?
You say, how will I be able, brother, to understand things that I know nothing about? Jesus said to Nicodemus, except the man be born again, he cannot see or understand the kingdom of heaven.
Jy sê, hoe sal ek in staat wees, broer, om dinge te verstaan waarvan ek niks weet nie? Jesus het vir Nicodemus gesê, as 'n man nie weer gebore word nie, kan hy die koninkryk van die hemel nie sien of verstaan nie.
Said the wind blows where it listeth, then thou cannot tell from whence it come or whether it goes.
Amen.
Which way it come from, or where it's going, or where it's been. So is everyone that's born of the Spirit.
Gesê die wind waai waar hy wil, en jy kan nie sê waar vandaan het kom, of waarin dit gaan nie. Waar vandaan dit gekom het, of waarin dit gaan, of waar dit was nie. So is elkeen wat gebore is uit die Gees.
You don't know where it comes from, where it's been, or where it's going. But you know one thing, where it's going to take you.
Amen.
Wherever it come from, it'll take you back with it.
Jy weet nie waar vandaan het kom, waar dit was, of waarin dit gaan nie. Maar jy weet een ding, waarin dit jou gaan neem. Waar vandaan dat ook al gekom het, dat sal jou terugneem saam met dit.
So, today, it behooves us to know what we're doing. Understand it. Now, if it doesn't bear record of the word, then it isn't God's Spirit. If it doesn't heal the sick, denies it, then it's not God's Spirit. God is a healer.
Amen.
So vandag betaam dit ons om te weet wat ons doen, dit te verstaan. Nou as dit nie getuig van die woord nie, dan is dit nie Godse gees nie. As dit nie die siekes genees nie, dit ontken, dan is dit nie Godse gees nie. God is 'n geneeser.
Once said, why did God ever let sin come on the earth? God was one unit at one time. In that unit was attributes. And he was a savior. By nature he was a savior. If there had never been a sinner, how would he ever been a savior? He couldn't save until he permitted sin.
Eenmaal soos eenmaal gesê is, hoekom het God ooit sonde op die aarde laat kom? God was eers een eenheid, en daar eenheid was eienskappe, en hy was 'n verlosser. Hy was 'n verlosser van natuur. As daar nooit 'n sonder was nie, hoe sou hy ooit 'n verlosser wees? Hy kon nie red voor hy sonde toegelaat het nie.
God's a healer. And he cannot heal unless there be somebody sick to heal. See, if there'd never been a sickness, there'd never been a healer. God being a healer, his own attributes projected these things. There had to be something to respond to that attribute that was in God.
God is 'n geneeser. Hy kan nie genees voor daar nie iemand siek is om te genees nie. Sien, as daar nooit 'n siekte was nie, sou daar nooit 'n geneeser wees nie. God wat 'n geneeser was, sy eie eienskappe het hierdie dinge geprojekteer. Daar moes iets wees om te reageer op daardie eienskappe daar in God was.
God, the word God means an object of worship. God wanted to be worshipped. So he had to project something that would worship him.
Amen.
Jesus said to the woman at the well, God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth.
God, die woord God beteken 'n voorwerp van aanbidding. God wou aanbid word, so hy moes iets projekteer wat hom so aanbid. Jesus het vir die vrou by die put gesê, God is 'n gees, en hulle wat hom aanbid, moet hom in gees en in waarheid aanbid.
So when the Spirit of God is near, what will take place? Salvation will be introduced.
Amen.
Salvation that will bring a spiritual worship.
Amen.
Not a singing of hymns altogether, but a worship in the Spirit.
So wanneer die Gees van God nabij is, wat sal gebeur? Verlossing sal bekend gemaak word, verlossing wat 'n geestelike aanbidding sal teweegbring. Nie sing van gesange eintlik nie, maar aanbidding in die Gees.
It's got to be so contrary to the intellect, is stunned by it. You can't understand God by intellectual faith. You must be born again. It's got to come to the heart.
Dit moet so teenstrydig wees met die intellect, dit word oorbluf daardeur. Jy kan nie God verstaan met intellektuele geloof nie. Jy moet wedergebore wees, jy moet na die hart toe kom.
It's got to be an experience. And when the experience is wrought by the Holy Spirit, then the same nature and the same power and the same reaction that happened on the church first will come again.
Amen.
For it's God in them.
Dit moet 'n ondervinding wees, en wanneer die ondervinding gebring word deur die Heilige Gees, dan sal dieselfde natuur en dieselfde krag en dieselfde reaksie wat eens met die kerk gebeur het, weer kom, want dis God in hulle.
Jesus said, a little while and the world won't see me no more, yet ye shall see me, for I as a personal pronoun, I'll be with you, even in you, to the end of the world.
Amen.
Then the works that I do shall you also.
Jesus het gesê, 'n klein tydjie in die wêreld sal my nie meer sien nie, tog sal julle my sien, want ek is 'n persoonlike voornaamwoord. Ek sal met julle wees selfs in julle tot aan die einde van die wêreld. Dan sal julle ook die werke doen wat ek doen.
Then when those works are produced in a church, it stirs the people, the outside people like it did there at the feast.
Dan wanneer daar die werke gedoen word in 'n kerk, bring dit die mense in beroering, die buitemense, soos dit daar gedoen het by die fees.
Who is this? What's the matter with those people? When those Galileans saw him coming on that little mule, they screamed and they shouted and they carried on like a bunch of drunken people.
Wie is hierdie? Wat makkeer daardie mense daardie Galileërs om sien kom het op daardie muiltjie? Het hulle gegil en geskree en hulle het aangegaan soos 'n klomp dronk mense.
Amen.
those priests that make them hold their peace. He said, if they hold their peace, the rocks will cry the same way. You see?
Daardie priesters, hulle het hulle stil gemaak. Hy het gesê, as hulle stil bly, sal die klippe net so uitroep. Julle sien?
On the day of Pentecost, when the Holy Spirit came into the people, they acted like they were drunk. Even so much as they scoffed and made fun of it. Said, these men are full of new wine.
Op die dag van Pinkster, toe die Heilige Gees in die mense ingekom het, het hulle opgetree asof hulle dronk was. Self tot so mate dat hulle daarvoor gelag en dit bespot het, gesê het, hierdie man is vol nieuwe wijn.
Peter said, ye men of Jerusalem and you that dwell in Judea, let this known unto you and hearken unto my words, for these are not drunken as you suppose, but this is that which is spoken by the prophet Joel. It'll come to pass in the last day, saith God, I'll pour my spirit out upon all flesh.
Petrus het gesê, julle mannen van Jerusalem, julle wat in Judea woon, laat het bekend wees aan julle en luister na my woorde, want diegene is nie dronk soos julle dink nie, maar dit is dit wat gesprek is deur die profeet Joel. Dit sal gebeur in die laaste dae, sê God, dat ek my geest sal uitstort op alle vlees.
When that same spirit is poured out upon a congregation of people, the same results will take place. Or you cannot put a life of a grapevine in a pumpkin and make it bear pumpkins. It'll bear grapes. By their fruits they are known.
Wanneer daar dieselfde geest uitgestort met op een vergadering van mense, sal dieselfde resultate plaasvind. Want jy kan nie lewe van een vingerstok in een pampoen sit en dit pampoen laat dra nie. Dit sal drywe daar aan hulle vruchte word hulle gekend.
The church is knowing, the world's wondering, who is it? What is this that's going on? They don't understand because they don't know God.
Word die kerk ken die wereld wonder, wie is dit? Wat is hierdie wat aangaan? Hulle verstaan nie, want hulle ken God nie.
Now when we see this coming to pass exactly like God said, we're waiting now, what is it? The Holy Spirit is introducing Christ.
Nou wanneer ons hierdie sien gebeur, precies soos God gesê het, wacht ons nou. Wat is dat die Heilige Geest stel Christus bekend?
Some glorious day, not across a hillside, riding on a mule, but coming out of glory, will come the Son of God.
Amen.
Wrapped in the righteousness of God's Spirit, riding on a white horse with his vesture dipped in blood, called King of Kings and Lord of Lords. The Word of God he will be.
Een glorierijke dag nie oor kan die hemel aan die rij op een mijl nie, maar waar het kom in die heerlijkheid sal die Seun van God kom, toegedraai in die gerechtigheid van Godse geest aan die rij op een wit perd met sy kleren gedroop in bloed, genoem Koning van Koning en Heere van Heere, die woord van God sal hy wees.
And following him through the skies will be 10,000s times 10,000s of thousands. The armies of heaven will come with him. What a glorious time that'll be.
Wat om deur die hemel volg sal tienduisende maal tienduisende van duisende wees. Die leers van die hemel sal saam met hom kom. Wat glorierijke tyd sal dit wees.
Singing, there'll be singing, there'll be shouting. There'll be sorrow, there'll be crying, there'll be weeping, there'll be wailing.
Sang, daar sal sang wees, daar sal uitroepen wees, daar sal hartseer wees. Daar sal geween wees, daar sal geheel wees, daar sal geweeklaag wees.
You'll be represented in one of those groups, friend. So make your decision this morning what group you'll be with while we bow our heads just a moment.
Jy sal verteenwoordig wees in een van haar groepe, vriend. So maak jy op besluit van morgen wat groep jy sal wees, terwijl ons net een oomblik ons hoofde buig.
Wondering at this time if there is any here who has not made their decision yet for Jesus Christ.
Wonder op hierdie tyd of daar enige hier is wat nog nie hulle besluit gemaak het vir Jesus Christus nie.
Yet you've been in the meetings and watched him give sight to the blind, hearing to the deaf, the lame, walking, seen him take the very thoughts out of the minds of the people and say, you're so and so, why did you do this and do that? Exactly what he said he would do. And yet you haven't yet become his servant. You've never got a witness.
Toch was jy in die dienst en het om die sig van die blindes sien gee gehoor aan die doofes die verlamdes versloop, om die eenste gedagtes uit die gemoed van die mense sien neem en sê, jy so en so, hoekom het jy dit en dat gedoen, precies wat hy gesê het, hy sal doen. En toch het jy nog nie sy dienskneg geword nie. Jy het nog nooit die getuienis ontvang nie.
No man can call Jesus the Christ only by the Holy Spirit. You say, I believe it because the Word says so. That's true. But the Word says that no man can say Jesus is Christ until you have received the Holy Ghost. No man can call Jesus the Christ only by the Holy Ghost.
Niemand kan Jesus die Christus noem nie net deur die Heilige Gees. Jy sê, ek glo dit, want die Woord sê so, dis waar. Maar die Woord sê dat niemand kan sê dat Jesus die Christus is, totdat jy die Heilige Gees ontvang het nie. Niemand kan Jesus die Christus noem nie net deur die Heilige Gees.
Have you not received this yet? And you'd like to, would you want to be remembered in prayer by raising up your hands and pray for me?
Het jy dit nog nie ontvang en jy sal graag jy onthou wil word in gebed, terwijl jou hand opsteek, sê, bid vir my.
I now confess to God that I want His Holy Spirit in my life to guide me, that I fully understand all His program that He has for me in life, that I might walk with Him as His servant. Would you raise your hand just before we pray? Lord bless you, sonny. Lord bless you, sister. God be with you. Let us pray.
Ek bely nou aan God dat ek sy Heilige Gees in my lewe wil hê om my te lei, dat ek sy program wat hy vir my het in die lewe ten volle sal verstaan, dat ek saam met hom kan wandel as sy dienskneg. Sal jy jou hand opsteek net voor ons bid, die Here seën ons seun, die Here seën ons suster, God wees met jou, kom ons bid.
Most gracious God, as we have read in thy word, where that when you entered into the city of Jerusalem where your people were gathered, there were those there who were expecting you. There was charge with your coming. You had promised you'd be at the feast. You'd meet them there. And they were looking for you. Others thought it was nonsense.
Genadigste God, soos ons in die woord gelees het, waar hy in die stad van Jerusalem ingegaan het, waar die volk vergader was, dat daar diegene daar was wat u verwacht het. Die lucht was gevlaai met u komst. U het beloof dat u by die feest sou wees, u sou hulle daar ontmoet, en hulle het gesoek na u. Ander het gedink, dit was ons.
Who was this anyhow? Just a Galilean make-believe prophet. A man that had been declared crazy by the council of churches.
Wie was hier in elk geval net een Galileer, profeet na bootser, een man wat mal verklaar is, deur die raad van kerke?
Well, they said, we know that you're mad, you got a devil. And it declared an insane person. And his congregation was declared insane.
Wel het hulle gesê, ons weet dat jy mal is, jy het een duivel en behoort verklaar te word as een krankzinnige persoon. Sy gemeente is krankzinnig verklaar.
And the man that introduced him, John the Baptist, was declared a wild, crazy man out of the wilderness. A hermit.
En die man wat hom bekend gestel het, Johannes die Doper, was verklaar as een wilde, mal man uit die woestijn, een kluisenaar.
Why, it was nothing. The ritzy congregations of that day didn't believe such a message. And those spirits that held them in bondage are holding millions today. Still they don't believe it.
Wel, dit was niks. Die swerige gemeentes van haar die dag het net so 'n boodskap geglo nie. Daar die geeste wat hulle gevange gehou het, hou miljoene gevange vandag. Hulle glo dit steeds nie.
But to those who were waiting, they knew their Lord had promised to come to the feast. And they were waiting, gathering themselves on the street and in the little rooms and anywhere they could, talking and waiting, and the whole atmosphere was charged with His coming.
Maar aan hulle wat gewag het, het hulle geweet, hulle Heer het beloof om na die feest toe te kom. En hulle het gewag, hulle self vergader in die straat en die kamertjes, ooral waar hulle kon. Gepraat en gewag, en die hele atmosfeer was gelaai met sy komst.
So is it today, Lord. You promised we'd be taken to the marriage feast of the Lamb. You'd come get the church. And we see signs appearing that you're coming. So the whole atmosphere is charged with your coming. We're waiting.
So is dan vandag, Here, eet ons beloof, ons sou geneem word na bruiloftsfees van die Lam. U sou die kerk kom haal en ons sien tekens verskyn dat u op pad is. So die hele atmosfeer is gelaai met die koms, ons wag.
There were some hands went up this morning, Lord, that they wasn't yet sure that they be called into that feast. We're watching for you to come.
Daar het 'n paar hande opgegaan vanmôre, Here, dat hulle nog nie seker was dat hulle ingeroep is in daardie fees nie. Ons hou dop vir u om te kom.
They tell us they've got bombs that can blow the whole world to pieces in one moment. They can look at a star over in Russia and time it exactly to Louisville, Kentucky in a split minute. Hit the moon and predicted it on 80 seconds.
Hulle sê vir ons, hulle het bomme wat die hele wêreld uitmekaar kan skiet binne 'n oomblik. Hulle kan kyk na 'n ster oor kan in Rusland en dit presies aftel na Louisville, Kentucky binne 'n breekdeel van 'n sekonde. Die maan tref en dit voorspel op 80 sekondes.
Oh Lord, we see those things appearing just as you said they would be. And they are well able to carry out their threats.
O Heer, ons sien daardie dinge verskyn net soos u gesê het hulle sou wees. En hulle is beslis in staat om hulle dreigemente uit te voer.
God, we turn the page and look at you're able to carry out your promise. For you're God and we're waiting for you to come. Take these people into thy care today, Lord. Grant unto them eternal life through Jesus our Lord.
En God, ons blaai die bladsy om en kyk en U is in staat om U belofte te vervul. Want U is God. Ons wag vir U om te kom. Neem hierdie mense onder die sorg vandag, Here, gee hulle ewige lewe deur Jesus ons Here.
Grant those that are sick and afflicted may be healed. Give us a great service tonight in the healing service coming up.
Gee dat diegene wat siek en beproef is genees mag word. Gee vir ons 'n wonderlike diens vanaand in die genesingsdiens wat kom.
Bless all together in every church that's represented here, the different peoples of different phases of faith. May they realize that it isn't the faith that the church that they go to that makes them what they are. It's their unadulterated faith that they have in the Son of God. All praise shall be thine, Father. We commit them to thee in Jesus' name. Amen.
Seën almal saam in elke kerk waar hier verteenwoordig is die verskillende mense van verskillende fases van geloof. Mag hulle besef dat dit nie geloof van die kerk is waarna hulle gaan. Wat hulle maak, wat hulle is nie. Dis hulle onvervalste geloof wat hulle in die Seun van God het. Alle eer sal U toekom, Vader. Ons vertrou hulle toe aan U. In Jesus naam, amen.
Jesus het dit ons betaal.
Dis wat Hy gedoen het.
Al my skuld ek hom. Sonder laat de brims hy vind, hy was, dit werd soos nieuw.
Now the message over, let's just worship the Lord and sing Him.
Nou is die boodskap verby, kom ons en bid net die Here en sang.
Jesus betaald het ons, alles skuld ek hom. Sonde laat die bloed my vlek, hy was dit wat soos nieuw. Waar my redder staan, daar het ek vereniging van sonde van kleed. O daar aan my hart is die bloed gewend. Eer sê sy naam, Eer sê sy naam, hier by die naam, Eer sê sy naam. O daar aan my hart is die bloed gewend, Eer sê sy naam.
Now let's not look at one another, let's look up. Raise our hands.
Nu kom eens kijk niet naar elkaar, nu kom eens kijk op, steek ons handen op. Het is wonderbaarlijk van zonde gered. Jezus blijft steeds dierbaar hier binnen mij. Daar bij die kruis neem hij mij toe in. Heere, sê sy naam.
Heere,
sê sy naam.
That precious name.
Heere, sê sy naam. Heere, sê sy naam. Daar in my hart is die bloed heaven. Heere, sê, sê naam.
Now I want you to turn and just shake hands with somebody in front of you, back of you, right and left side while we're saying this.
Nou wil ek hee julle met omdraai en net handskud met iemand voor julle, achter julle, rechter, linkerkant, terwijl ons hier die sing.
Come to this fountain so rijk.
And sweet, help your arme soul aan die redders voet. O, spring in vandaag en word ver.
Now let's raise your hands.
Kom ons steek ons handen op.
Glory,
Heere, sê, sê naam. Heere, sê. Say now, you say, say now.
Oh,
head of the heart is the blood heaven. You say, say now.
Doesn't make you feel wonderful? All scoured out now waiting. Oh, how wonderful.
Laat het julle wonderlijk voel, heeltemal uitgeskeer nou in afwachting. O, hoe wonderlijk.
Kom
naar hier de fontein so rijk en soet. Let your arme
poor soul
and the heilands speak. O, spring in vandag en word vervolmaak. Heere, sê, sê naam. Heere, sê, sê die
precious
naam. Heere, sê, sê die bloed gewend. Heere, sê, sê naam.
Doesn't that do something to you? Think of this.
Doen dit nie iets aan julle nie? Dink hieraan.
Ek
is wonderbaarlijk van sonde gered. Jesus blijft steeds dierbaar.
Abide. You abide me and my word in you.
Blij as jy in my blij en my woorde in blij.
Daar
by die kruis neem my my toe in. Heere, sê, sê.
Just put your mind on him as you worship him.
Nou dink net aan hom soos jy hom aanbid. Heere, sê, sê.
What could we do, Lord, without you? This is the hour of your appearing. You're soon coming, Lord.
Wat kon ons doen, Heere, sonder U? Heere, hierdie is die uur van U verskyning. U kom binnenkort, Heere. Daar in my hart is die bloed gewend. Heere, sê, sê naam.
my. There's something about that just goes through me till every fiber of my body just shakes. That's the Holy Spirit here.
I say unto thee today, my servant, yea, even as thou hast stood in the midst of this my people, that I have ordained this day unto thee, saith the Lord. For I have anointed thee, yea, thou art my prophet, and I shall be with thee today. Where thou layest hands upon this my people, who are sick and afflicted in body, I say unto thee, my people, have faith in me, the living God. For I shall bring to pass those things that I have promised, for I am able to bring to pass my word. Therefore I say unto you this day, fear thou not to believe in me, the living God, for I shall be in thy midst in a great and mighty way.
Amen. Thanks be to God. That's what I was speaking of.
O kwiste, daar is iets daaraan, wat net deur my gaan tot elke vesel in my lichaam net bewe. Dis die Heilige Gees hier. Amen, dank God, dis waarin van ek gepraat het.
My geloof kyk op na U. U lam van Golgotha, goddelike heiland, hoor my nou wel, ek bid, neem al my sonde weg. Net u wees.
I sing that for a purpose. The Lord has given me a text for tonight through that interpretation. My word.
Ek het dit gesing vir 'n doel. Die Here het vir my 'n teks gegee vir vanaand. Deur haar uitleg, my woord sien.
Wow.
Wil ek lewens donker dood op bewandel en droefheid my omvul. Wees u my God. Laat duisternis verander in dag. Vier hart seer vrees sal weg. Of laat my nie afdwaal van U af weg.
2 years ago in the catacombs in San Angelo, catacombs in Rome, I was standing down there and I looked down there and I seen where they carved a picture of those saints 2,000 years ago of Jesus. One of them packing the lost sheep on his back, the other healing the sick and afflicted. I stood there with my hands up like this. I was saying, while life's dark maze I tread and griefs around me spread.
2 jaar geleden in die catacombes in St. Angelo catacombes in Rome, het ek daar onder gestaan, ek het daar afgekyk en ek het gesien waar hulle die prentjie van haar die heiliges uitgekerf het, 2000 jaar gelede van Jesus. Een van hulle die verlore skaap op sy rug gedra, die ander een wat die siekes en beproefdes genees het. En ek het daar gestaan met my hande op soos die ek het gesing, wyl ek lewensdonker doolhof behandel en droefheid my omvul.
Then I went out there over to the Colosseum and stood on the grounds there where they fed the saints to the lions and the gladiators killed them.
Toe daar uitgegaan oor kan na die Colosseum toe en daar op die gronde gestaan het waar hulle heiliges vir die leeu's gevoer het en die swaardvegters hulle doodgemaak het.
Our oh God, faith of our fathers living still burning in my heart, Lord, never let it move from there, nor let me ever stray from thee aside. That's right. How I love him.
Ek het gedink, o God, geloof van ons vaders, wat steeds leef, brand in my hart. Here, Laat me nooit daaruit laat weggaan nie, of laat me nooit afdwaal van u af weg. Dis reg hoe lief het ek om nie.
Daar is a fontein gevul met bloed, getrek uit Immanuel's aan, en sondag gedompel in die vloed, verloor elke zon de flame, verloor elke zon de flame, verloor elke zon de flame, en zo.
Aren't you happy you did that? Wonder if we just shut our eyes and say,
is jullie niet blij jullie dit gedoen nie? Wonder als ons net ons oor sluit, sê,
is de levende dief was blind te zien, die fontein daar en sê daar, en daar kan ik toch slaag soos hy, al my sonde weg kom was, al my sonde weg kom was, al my sonde weg kom was, en daar kan ek toch veel soos hy, al my sonde weg kom was.
You feel good? Just the worship of the Holy Spirit, the blessings of the Lord upon you. Now, we expect to see you tonight, and the prayer card's given out now at 6:30 sharp, so you won't interfere with the rest of the service, and you desire, come.
Voel julle goed? Net die aanbidding van die Heilige Gees, die seëning van die Here op julle? Nou ons verwag om julle vanavond te sien, en die gebedskaarte word nou stiptelik om 6:30 uitgegee, sodat julle nie inmeng met die rest van die diens nie. En as julle wil, kom.
And how many is going to heaven by the grace of God? Let's see your hand. We're going up.
En hoeveel gaan die hemel toe deur die genade van God? Laat ons jou hand sien. Ons gaan op.
I've got a Father over yonder. I've got a Father over yonder. I've
got a Father over yonder.
Op die other shore,
een mooi dag sal ek om ontmoet ook, een mooi dag sal ek om ontmoet ook, mooi dag sal ek om ontmoet, op die other shore, door daar die mooi dag kom dalk morgen, daar die mooi dag kom dalk morgen, daar die mooi dag kom dalk morgen. Op die oever daar, hoe sal dit nie blye thuiskom wees nie, sal dit nie blye thuiskom wees nie, sal dit nie blye thuiskom wees nie, op die oever daar.
You like him old hymn? Oh, you can have all your little chopped up shotties that you want. Give me them old heartfelt blood songs that does something down in here. Wrote by the Holy Spirit, penned out by God. They're real. Well, the Lord bless you real good. Hope to see you tonight. Turn the service to the pastor now.
Hoe julle van daardie ou liedere? O, julle kan al julle ou verkorte liedjes hou wat julle het. Geef me daardie ou innige bloedliedere wat iets doen hier onderin. Skryf die Heilige Gees neergepen deur God, hulle is echt. Wel, die Heere sien hulle baie rijkelijk. Hoop julle vanavond te sien. gee die diens oor aan die pastoor nou, Bro Jackson.
Barmel, there may be some here that can't come to the healing service, and I just want to be anointed and prayed for. There's a whole bunch of us ministers here would be glad to minister to you in any way that we could. Now, the regular healing service will be tonight. That is, if you can stay and wait. If you can't, come right here now.
Formeel, daar mag sommige hier wees wat nie na die genesingsdienste kan kom vanavond nie, wat net gesalf en voorgebid wil word. Daar is 'n hele klomp van ons predikers hier, wat julle graag op enige manier sal bedien wat ons kan. Nou die gewone genesingsdienst sal vanavond wees. Nou dit is as julle kan bly en wag. As julle nie kan nie, kom net nou hier na toe.
There's a lady's got to go in the bank. That's got a heart case or something. Or, I mean, she's up here. Somebody pointed her finger up here. The lady here has got heart trouble. It can't come back tonight. It's real serious. And wants to, and can't come in the line.
Daar is 'n dame wat moet gaan aan die achterkant. Sy het 'n hartgeval of so iets. Ek glo sy is hierbo. Iemand het hulle vinger hier boontoe gewys. Die dame hier wat haar probleme het, wat nie kan terugkom vanavond nie, wat baie ernstig en wil, en nie in die ry kan kom nie.
I see the reason we ask for the line. In there, we can, myself, everyone has a different way of praying. Some praise in one way, some another. Mine, if I know what I'm talking about, then I can act.
Nou sien die rede waarom ons vir die ry vra, daarin kan ons, ek self, almal het 'n verskillende manier van bid, party bid op een manier, ander op 'n ander. Myne, as ek weet waarvan ek praat, dan kan ek optree.
But if I went out here to say I was going to fix an automobile and I don't know one thing about it, I'd get me a wrench and look around. I wouldn't know. See?
As ek hier uitgegaan het, sê ek sou 'n motor herstel. Ek het nie geweet een ding daarvan nie. Wel, sou ek vir my 'n moersleutel kry en rondkyk. Ek sou nie weet nie, sien?
Well, now, many people just has that predominating faith that goes right out there and challenges those things and casts them away. To me, I have to see what God's plan is for that first, you see.
Wel, nou, baie mense het net daardie oorheersende geloof wat regtig daar uitgaan en daardie dinge uitdaag en hulle uitgooi. Vir my, ek moet eers sien wat God se plan daarvoor is, julle sien?
You have to watch, a prophetic gift is a strange thing. You can do things with it to get yourself in trouble. How many knows that?
Jy moet dop op profetiese gawe se vreemde dinge. Jy kan dinge daarmee doen, jouself in die moeilikheid laat beland. Hoeveel weet dit?
Look at Elijah. I believe it was, yes, Elijah. He was a young fellow, went bald-headed, and some little children is teasing him about being bald-headed. So why don't you go up like Elijah did?
Kijk naar Elia, geloof ik, was dit, ja, Elia, hij was een jong kerel, het bleskop geraak, een paar jong kinders het omgespot, omdat hij bleskop was, gesê, hoekom gaan hier nie op soos Elia het nie?
And he turned around and put a curse on those children, and 42 of them was killed. That ain't the nature of the Holy Spirit. See? That prophet angered and just put a curse on what he said.
Hy het omgedraai en 'n vloek op daardie kinders geplaas en 42 van hulle is doodgemaak. Dit is nie natuur van die Heilige Gees nie, sien. Dit was daardie profeet wat kwaad gemaak is, net 'n vloek geplaas het op wat hy gesê het.
Jesus said on down in the scriptures that I read this morning, if you say to this mountain be moved and don't doubt in your heart but believe that what you said will come to pass, you can have what you said. There you are. So you have to watch what you're doing.
Jesus het gesê verder in die skrifte wat ek vanmôre gelees het, as jy vir hierdie berg sê word opgehou en nie in jou hart twyfel nie, maar glo wat jy gesê het sal gebeur, kan jy kry wat jy gesê het. Daar het julle dit sien. Jy moet kyk wat jy doen.
Now, look at Moses. He had power. It wasn't God's will to bring water out of the rock. How many know that the second time? You're supposed to speak to it, not smite it. God told him to speak to it. He turned around and smote it because he had the power to do it.
Nou kyk na Moses. Hy het mag gehad. Dit was nie God se wil om water uit die rots te bring. Hoeveel weet dit? Die tweede keer nie. Hy was veronderstel om daarmee te praat, nie dit te slaan nie. God het hom gesê om daarmee te praat. Hy het regtig omgedraai en dit geslaan, omdat hy die krag gehad het om dit te doen.
God took him up on the mountain and said, look over yonder. See the land, but I'll not let you go over. Because what you done down there to rock. See? So he had to watch and do it. Now that's the reason I'm always trying.
God het hom teen een berg opgeneem en gesê, kyk oor soontoe, sien die land. Maar ek sal jou nie laat oorgaan nie as gevolg van wat jy daaronder by die rots gedoen het. Sien? So jy moet dop hou as jy dit doen. Dis hoekom ek altyd probeer.
And I feel like that soon, maybe within the next few days, I have a feeling that God's going to speak to me again. See? I'm laying in the woods day and night, waiting for that time. I've been feeling for the last two or three weeks that he was going to speak to me. I believe I'm going to have something change. I've looked forward for it for a long time. The one, the prediction that was given here not long ago of what would take place, it did. But it just seems like down in me there's something moving.
En ik voel dat binnenkort, misschien binnen die volgende paar dagen, ik het gevoel dat God weer met mij gaan praten zien. Ik leid dag en dag in die woude in afwachting voor haar tijd. Ik het gevoel voor de afgelopen twee of drie weken dat hij met mij gaan praten. Ik geloof ik ga iets hebben wat gaan veranderen. Ik zie al voor een lang tijd uit daarna. Die een, die voorspelling wat gegeven is hier lang geleden niet, van wat zou plaatsvinden dit het. Maar het lijkt net of daar iets onder mij aan de beweging is.
And I just stay out, go early in the morning, out at night, waiting, watching, to see what he'll say. And every once in a while, I'll get down on my knees and say, are you here, Lord? Is there anything that you want your servant to know?
En ik blijf net beter gaan vroeg in die morgen, eet in die avond, en aanwachten om te zien wat hij zal zeggen. En elke nou en dan zal ik op mijn knieën gaan en zeggen, is hij hier, Heere? Is daar enige iets wat hij wil hebben, je dienstknecht moet weten?
That's the reason I'm watching. I want the hour to come where we won't have to have discernment. Where I have faith without it.
Dus ook om ik dop hoor. Ik wil hier de eer moet aanbreken. Waar ons niet meer onderscheiding hoeft te hebben. Waar ik geloof zal hij daar zonder.
Now I think a vision comes here. Say, this woman or this lady or whoever it is. See, I don't know, man, whoever you might be. Will come up here. I never seen you in my life. And yet he shows me there who you are. What's the matter with you? Where you come from? What you did to cause this?
Ik denk een visioen kom hier, sê hierdie vrou of hierdie dame of wat het ook al is sien. Ek weet nie, een man. Wat u ook al nog weer sal hier opkom. Ek het u nog nooit in my leven gesien, nie toch. Ek wees my daar wie jy is. Wat u mekeer, waar jy vandaan kom, wat jy gedoen het om dit te veroorzaak.
There has to be a cause for everything. And what if somebody sinned? Maybe they did do something you ought not to have done. Maybe they ought to have done something they did not do. Or something on that manner.
Daar moet de oorzaak van alles wees. En wat is iemand gezondig het? Misschien hulle het iets gedoen wat hulle nie moes gedoen het nie. Misschien moes hulle iets gedoen het wat hulle nie gedoen het nie. Of iets in daar die lijn.
And here they are with the God permitting Satan to hold that curse on them. To bring him to something, to obedience. Sickness is sometimes a whip God uses. To bring obedience.
Hier is hulle met God wat Satan toelaat om daar die vloek op hulle te hou, om hulle naar iets toe te brengen, naar gehoorzaamheid. Ziekte is partijmaal een zweep wat God gebruikt om tot gehoorzaamheid te brengen.
And while that person stand there, I say, oh hallelujah, glory to God, praise God, and norm with arm, pray over him. And I happen to cast that evil spirit off of him. And God permitted it to be put on there. I'm in trouble right then with God. You know what I mean?
En wat als die persoon daar staan en ik zeg, oh halleluja, glorie en God, prijs God. Sal hulle met olie bid oor en ek drijf net die bose geeste uit hulle uit en God het toegelaten dat daar gesit is. Ek is net daar in die moeilijkheid bij God, sien wat ik bedoel, ek.
But when I see there that the Lord says a certain thing, maybe Satan just did it. And I see there's nothing in that person's life to enter, then I have faith to walk up there. I have faith because I seen him when he come to me and told me to do it.
Maar als ik daar zie dat die Heere zekere ding sê, misschien het Satan dit net gedoen. En ik zie daar is niks in haar persoon zijn leven om te hinder nie. Dan het ik geloof om daar op te stappen. Ik het geloof, want ik het om gezien toe hy naar mij toe gekom het en voor mij gesê het om dit te doen te zien.
And then another thing is, maybe if they've done something wrong, and I say, you did a certain thing. That's right. Well, make that right. I promise before God I'll make it right.
En dan nog een ding, misschien als hulle iets verkeerd gedoen het, en ik zeg, het is zekere ding gedoen, dat is recht. Wel maak de recht, ik beloof voor God, ik zal de recht maken.
Look back again and see him well out in our years to come, still well. Then you know God's already spoken. Just waiting for you to say the word, that's all. That's what they...
Kijk weer terug en zien hulle gezond daar buiten jaren daarna steeds gezond, dan weet jy, God heeft het al reeds gesprek. Wacht net voor mij om die woord te spreken, dat is al zien. Dus wat het vergt.
That's why I watch, make my ministry slow, take each case and watch it. Then I know what I'm talking about, see? I know exactly what to say to the person.
Dus die manier ik kijk, maak mijn bediening stadig, neem elke geval en oude dop, dan weet ik waarvan ik praat zien. Ik weet precies wat om voor die persoon te zeggen.
Now, there has been times I've seen death over a person. I wouldn't say nothing. I just say, the Lord bless you. Have faith in God. God will heal you. You just have faith.
Daar was tye wat ek dood oor 'n persoon gesien het, wat ek niks sou sê nie. Ek sê net, die Here sê nou, hy geloof in God. God sal jou genees as jy net geloof sal hê.
Go on like that, knowing in my heart that they're not going to live because, well, you just don't want to tell them that. Unless you have to. If the Holy Spirit reveals it.
Aangaan soos daarin en die weet in my hart dat hulle nie gaan lewe nie. Want wel, jy wil dit nie vir hulle vertel nie, behalwe as jy moet, as die Heilige Gees dit openbaar.
You know, it's been done many times. Some say, might as well make ready, you're going, there ain't nothing going to save you.
Jy weet, dit is baie keer gedoen. Hulle vertel, sê, kan het jou wel gereed maak. Jy gaan, daar is niks wat jou gaan red nie.
I had a little girl here some time ago. The father said, if he healed that little girl, he'd be a Christian. I wanted that family to be a Christian. I went out to the house. The little child had double pneumonia. They give her all the penicillin that they could give her. Didn't take any effect. She's got lower and lower and lower.
Ek het 'n dogtertjie hier gehad, 'n tyd gelede. Die vader het gesê, as daardie dogtertjie sou genees, sou hy 'n Christen wees. Ek wou hê die familie moet 'n Christen wees. Ek het na die huis toe gegaan, die kindjie het dubbele longontsteking gehad. Hulle het vir haar al die penicillin gegee wat hulle vir haar kon gee. Het geen effek gehad nie. Sy het net laer en laer en laer geraak.
And I went out to see her. I went in there and I said, I don't know. I said, I'm going to pray. And I went in and prayed for her. And with all my heart.
En ek het afgegaan om haar te sien. Ek het daar ingegaan en ek het gesê, ek weet nie. Ek het gesê, ek gaan bid. En ek het ingegaan vir haar gebid met my hele hart.
And the doctor come that afternoon and said, her fever's dropped. Next morning he come, said, that child's so much better. Said she can get up by the night.
En die dokter het gekom daar die middag gesê, haar koors het afgeneem. Volgende oggend het hy gekom gesê, daardie kind is soveel beter gesê. Sy kan teen die aand opstaan.
Oh, the father and I went to see her, met me, and he was rejoicing. He said, oh, brother Branham. And I said, Lee, I'm so glad to see your baby like that. And the Holy Spirit appeared to me, said, she's not going to live but 3 days.
Oor die vader, toe ek haar gaan sien het, het my ontmoet en hy het gejuig. Hy het gesê, o, bro Branham. En ek het gesê, Lee, ek is so blij om jou baba te sien soos daarie. En die Heilige Gees het aan my verskyn gesê, sy gaan nie langer as 3 dae lewe nie.
And the father was going to come to Christ. Said, now when you have your meeting, I'm ready to be baptized. Him and his family. Now I couldn't tell him. I hated to tell him. I knew the baby was going to die. I went back and told my wife, told all a lot of friends and my neighbors and things, the baby ain't going to live. Little girl about 8 years old. I said, she ain't going to live. She'll be dead within 3 days.
En die vader sou na Christus toe kom gesê, nou wanneer jy jou diens hou, is ek gereed om gedoop te word. Hy en sy familie nou ek kon hom nie sê nie. Ek het gehaat om hom te sê. Ek het geweet die baba sou sterf. Ek het teruggegaan, my vrou vertel en baie van die vriende, my bier en dinge, die baba gaan nie lewe nie. Dogtertjie omtrent 8 jaar oud, ek het gesê, sy gaan nie lewe nie. Sy sal dood wees binne 3 dae.
I seen that mother stand there crying, bowed her head 3 times, the tears run down, see a little white casket pass through the room, just want to stand there. I said, she's going to go.
Ek het die moeder daar sien staan en die heel haar hoof 3 keer gebuig. Die trane wat afloop, ek een klein wit kussie gesien wat deur die kamers gaan. Toe ek daar gestaan het, ek het gesê, sy sal gaan.
What said, you ought to go tell, Lee. And I said, I don't want to tell him. I said, I love little Beatrice first, and you all know who I'm talking about. So I said, I love little Beatrice, and I don't want her to know it, and I don't want to tell the father. And I said, I don't know what to do, but I know the baby. In 3 days, she was gone. See? I said, I didn't want to tell the father.
Wel gesê, jy behoort vir Lee te gaan sê. Ek gesê, ek wil hem nie sê nie. Ek gesê, ek is lief vir klein Beatrice eerste, en ek, julle weet van wie ek praat. So ek gesê, ek is lief vir klein Beatrice, en ek wil nie, he, sy moet dit weet nie. En ek wil nie vir die vader vertel nie. En ek het gesê, ek weet nie wat om te doen nie, maar ek weet die baba, binne 3 dae was sy weg, sien. Ek gesê, ek wil nie die vader vertel nie, sien.
Now that way, now lots of times I went and prayed in Africa there where there was only about 3 or 4 people on the platform. And when something take place on a platform, I just made a congregational prayer. And 25,000 miracles taking place at once. See? It's the people's faith.
Nou daardie manier, nou baie keer het ek gaan bid in Afrika daar, waar daar net 3 of 4 mense op die platform was. En wanneer iets sou gebeur op die platform, het ek net 'n gebed vir die gemeente gebid en 25,000 wonderwerker op een slag gebeur sien. Dis die mense se geloof.
A lot of times we bring the people right up to the platform, lay hands on them, pray for them, send them out, they go out and get well. See? So, it's just what other people think. It's their faith anyhow. But to curse a thing, I want to know first what I'm doing. That's me doing it then.
Nou, baie keer sou ons die mense regtig op die platform bring. Hand op hulle lê vir hulle bid, hulle uitstuur, hulle gaan uit en word gesond sien. So dis net wat die mense dink, dis in elk geval hulle geloof. Maar om 'n ding te vervloek, wil ek eers weet wat ek doen. Dis ek wat dit kan doen.
If you come have hands laid on, that's your faith, that's what you believe. You understand what I mean now, everybody? See? And I'm afraid to say.
As jy kom, hande opgelê word, dis jou geloof, dis wat jy glo. Verstaan julle nou almal wat ek bedoel? Sien, ek is bang om te sê.
Here comes a person I don't know anything about, I've never seen before. Brother Bram, I got so and so with me. I got cancer, I got tuberculosis. I'm just afraid to say that. See, I don't know what I'm doing. See, I just rather say, I pray for you. See, like that.
Hier kom 'n persoon, ek weet niks van hulle af nie, het nog nooit van tevore gesien nie. Bro Branham, ek het so en so saam met my. Dis ek het kanker, ek het tuberkulose. Ek is net bang om dit te sê, sien, ek weet nie wat ek doen nie, sien. Ek sou net liewer sê, ek sal vir jou bid, sien, soos dit.
But when I see a vision, see what's going to take place. That's different. See, I know what to do. I understand now why. It's just like walking in anything, but a lot of times I pray for the people hundreds of times.
Maar wanneer ek 'n visioen kan sien, sien wat sal gebeur, dis anders sien. Ek weet wat om te doen, ek verstaan dan wat. Dis net soos om in enigiets in te stap, maar baie keer bid ek vir die mense honderde kere.
Brother Shire sitting right back there, I'm looking at him now. I've been somewhere to a funeral service, buried Sister Roberson's mother.
Broer Shire, daar agter, ek kyk nou na hom. Ek was iewers na 'n begrafnis toe, Sister Robins en sy moeder begrawe.
Brother Shire, I never seen a man in any more condition just than he was in. Migraine headaches or something, or I don't know, and he got to a place that's unconscious like, didn't know nothing.
Broer Shire, ek het nog nooit 'n man in 'n erger toestand gesien waarin hy was nie. Ek skeel hoofpyne of so iets, ek weet nie. En hy het 'n punt bereik waar hy soort van bewusteloos was, niks geweet het nie.
Walked out of his room, just had a word of prayer, walked back out. I said, just as certain as I'm standing here, you'll be healed. That was it. Walked right out.
Reg in sy kamer ingeloop, net 'n woord van gebed gehad, weer uitgeloop. Ek het gesê, net so seker as wat ek hier staan, sal hy genees word. En dit was dit, reg het uitgeloop.
Miss Woods, her mother, laying dying with a cancer on her face. So, you know what it is, you even touch your lip here, and here, you can die in a little bit.
Mevrou Wood daar, haar moeder was stervend aan kanker op haar gesig gelê. Julle weet wat dit is. Jy sel net jou lip hier aanraak hier binne, kan jy binne 'n oomblik sterf.
A bee stung a man down here below New Albany recently. Stung him on the lip, he died about 2 minutes. Anything right here, don't ever squeeze nothing on your lips because it runs to the nerve, it runs to your brain.
'N bee het 'n man gesteek hier onder in die elbow, onlangs hom op die lip gesteek. Hy het binne omtrent 2 minute gesterf. Enigiets hier rond, moet nooit enigiets druk op jou lippe nie. Want dit loop na die senuwee wat na jou brein toe loop.
Really people, a man should never shave over their lips. That's exactly right. When your razor pulls, tears comes in your eyes. It's bad, right in there, because the main nerve.
Eintlik mense, 'n man moet nooit oor sy lippe skeer nie. Dis presies reg. As jou skeermes trek, kom daar trane in jou oë. Dis sleg net daar binne op die hoofsenuwee.
Here some time ago, I was over here where Jean Leo. There's a girl there, worked at the apothecary. Down here at the apothecary. And I went in there to get some kind of something or other for my kids to get vitamins and stuff for their colds and so forth. And she is telling out there in the neighborhood.
Hier 'n tyd gelede was ek oorkant waar Jean en Leo, daar was 'n meisie daar wat gewerk het by die apteek. Hier onder by die apteek, ek daar ingegaan om een of ander iets te kry vir my kinders om vitamine te kry en goed vir hulle verkoues en so voort. Sê hy dit daar buite in die buurt rond vertel.
There's a certain minister there. He said, do you mean to tell me that Brother Branham would give one of his children medicine? And it's not knowing. And I said, well, if that I ain't got a bit more faith in nothing in the world.
Daar was 'n sekere prediker daar. Hy het gesê, wil jy vir my sê dat Bro Branham vir een van sy kinders medisyne gee? Sien, dis nie bekend nie. En ek het gesê, wel, en hy gesê, ek het net so min geloof in hom as enigiets in die wêreld.
Just 2 days after that, his shaving cut his lip, squeezed it like that. He was in the hospital the next day under oxygen tent. About 4 or 5 days later, come out of his face swell like that thing. come out like that because he squeezed the place on his lip. See? You have to be careful what you do about that. That's lip trouble in here.
In het tweede en daarna had hij geskeerd zijn lip raak gesneden, het gedrukt zoals daardie. En hij was in die hospitaal die volgende dag onder zuurstof ten. Omtrent 3 of 4 dagen later uitgekomen zijn gezicht opgezwel zoals dit zien. Uitgekomen zoals daardie omdat hij een plek op zijn lip gedrukt het zien. Moet voorzichtig wees wat je daarmee doet. Daar die lipprobleem hier binnen.
Now, back to the spirit, the spiritual side. See, you have to know what you're approaching, what you're doing. If you don't know, don't do it.
Nou terug naar die geestelijke kant zien. Je moet weten wat je benadert, wat je doet. Als je niet weet, nie, moet dat niet doen. Nie.
Now, in prayer for the sick. Oh, I could say many, many things. Miss Woods, I was speaking of, her mother, a cancer done hit down into these veins. Her face is swelled out. Leo, Jean and I was in Michigan. And we heard it on the phone. My wife called me and said, Miss Woods' mother's a dying.
Nou, een gebed voor die ziek is ook aan baie dingen sê. Mevrouw Hoed, waarvan ik gepraat had, haar moeder kanker het klaar in daar die aarde ingegaan hier. Haar gezicht was opgeswel. Ik, Leo Jean, was in Michigan en ons het dit oor die telefoon gehoor. Mevrouw Hoed me gebel gesê, mevrouw Hoed, sy moeder is stervend.
I walked across the river. There sat Miss Woods all tore up. She said her mother dying. I went into the room and stayed there with her a long time. No vision, but just as I walked to her, just something inside of me said she's going to live.
Ik het oor de rivier geloop, daar het mevrouw Hoed gesit, baie ontsteld. Sy het gesê, haar ma is stervend, ek in die kamer ingegaan, en lang tijd daar by haar gebleef, geen visioene. Maar net toe ek na haar toe loop, het iets binnen in my net gesê, sy gaan leven.
I walked back out, Mr. and Miss Wood sat there and said, well, what did the Lord say? Did you see a vision? I said, no. They, right quick, they've been in a meeting, seen the visions. They got downcast.
Ek het weer uitgeloop. Meneer en mevrouw Wood het daar gesit, gesê, wel, wat het die Heere gesê, het die visioen gesien? Ek sê, nee, hulle, sommer gauw, hulle was in het dienst sien, en het die visioen gesien, hulle was neergedrukt.
But just in a minute, I said, but something told me, it's as much thus saith the Lord as a vision, that the woman's going to live. And she did.
Maar net binnen een oomblik het gesê, maar iets het vir my gesê, dat net soveel so spreek die Heere as een visioen, dat die vrou gaan leven. En sy het,
a cancer over here, down at her face like that. And here, done went into the bone, eat all the bone out, and things around like that, all the meat down into the bone like that. And she's living today, not just hardly a scar there where it was at. See?
A kanker hier ook aan, onder op haar gezicht soos daarie, en hier het dit klaar in die been ingegaan, al die been weggevreed, en goed daar rondom dit al die vlees onder die been soos daarie, sy leven vandag net skaarse litteken, daar waar dit was, sien?
And what scared her, the doctor gave her a shot in it and just scared it on out, you see. And that did her, try to burn it off or something they tried to do to it.
En wat verspreid het, die dokter het haar inspuiting daarin gegee, en dit het verder verspreid, hulle sien, dit het, of dit probeer afbrand, of iets wat hulle daarin probeer doen het.
Now, it's a people's faith, what you got faith in, if thou, here, Jeremiah said, come lay your hands on my girl, my daughter, and she'll live, you remember that?
Nou, dis die mense geloof, waarin jy geloof het, as jy, hier het Jairus gesê, kom lê je hand op my meisie, my dochter, en sy sal leven. Onthou julle dit?
The Roman said, I'm not worthy you come under my roof. Just speak the word, my servant lives. Is that right? There your heart depends on the faith.
Die Romeine gesê, ek is nie waardig dat u on my dak kom en spreek net die woord in my dienstig leven. Is het recht? Daar het julle dit, het hang van die geloof.
Now, is a lady here's got the heart trouble that couldn't come back tonight? If she's here, on the left. All right, sir. All right, young lady, if you want to come right up this way now, you just come right ahead. Anybody else, you're welcome.
Nou, is die dame hier wat haar probleem het, wat nie vanavond kan terugkom nie, as sy hier is, aan die linkerkant, goed meneer. Goed jong dame, as jy recht boontoe sal kom na hierdie kant toe, kom jy net recht vorentoe. Enige iemand anders, jy is welkom.
I want Brother Cash and your brother here. I believe Brother Beeler's in the midst too, isn't he? Come here, Brother Beeler. Another preacher? Any of the ministers that we come now, we want to pray for this young woman.
Ek wil hee, broer Cash, broer, jylle broer sê, ek geloof, broer Beeler is ook in die midde, is hy nie, kom hier, broer Beeler, nog een prediker, enige van die predikers wat nou sal kom, ons wil vir hierdie jong vrou bid.
They said it was heart trouble, is that right? That's the greatest killer we have, heart trouble. But do you know Jesus lives in the heart? Have you accepted him in there? Or you live here in the city, do you? Oh, hi.
Hulle het gesê, dit was hartprobleme, is dit reg? Dis die grootste moordenaar wat ons het, hartprobleme. Maar weet jy, Jesus woon in die hart, het jy hom daar binnen aanvaar, jy woon hier in die stad, woon jy? Ohio.
You can be healed of your heart trouble. God is a healer. He heals a heart. He heals every member of the body, every organ.
Jy kan genees word van jou hartprobleme. God is die geneeser. Hy genees die hart. Hy genees elke deel van die lichaam, elke orgaan.
Now, come on this way, brother. Let's come with it. I want the congregation to bow their heads.
Nou kom oor na hierdie kant toe, broers, kom na waar die dames. Ek wil hê die gemeente moet hulle hoof buig as hulle sal, terwyl ons bid.
Thou dost make the heart. You make it to grow and to live. You can build a new wall.
Yes, sir.
Where the old has been torn down. For thou art God and God alone.
U maak die hart, u laat het groei en lewe, u kan een nieuwe wand bou, waar die oude afgebreek is, want u is God en God alleen.
Now I think, what if this was my sister, the Lord, my wife Nina, or my girl Rebecca? I want the church to pray with all that it is.
Yes, Lord.
A prayer of faith for my child, for my wife or loved one.
Ek dink, wat as hierdie my sister Dolores was my vrou meer of my meisie Rebecca? Ek sou by hierdie kerk moet bid met alles wat in ons is, Heere, gebed van geloof vir my kind of my vrou of geliefde.
Perhaps it's somebody's daughter and maybe somebody's wife and maybe some baby's mother. She says she loves you and she's accepted you as her savior. And she has a right to come to these privileges.
Yes.
Misschien is dit iemand se dochter en misschien iemand se vrou. Dit mag een of ander babe se moeder wees. Sy het gesê, sy het u lief en sy het u aanvaar as haar verlosser en sy het reg om te kom na hierdie voordele.
And we come upon the authority of your invitation.
Yes, Lord.
To minister these gifts of healing. And by laying hands upon her, may the word of God be made manifest in her body to take away this heart.
En ons kom op die gesag van u uitnodiging, om aan haar hierdie gawes van genesing te bedien en deur hande op haar te lê, mag die woord van God gemanifesteer word in haar lichaam, om hierdie haar probleem weg te neem.
We can do it. Upon the basis of Jesus Christ's own word, saying that the prayer of faith shall save the sick,
yes,
and God shall raise them up. Now in Jesus Christ's name, let the heart trouble leave our sister. May she go with never one time a speck of it no more.
Ons bestraf dit op die basis van Jesus Christus' eie woord, wat sê dat die gebed van geloof sal die siekes red. God sal hulle oprig, nou in Jesus Christus naam. Laat die hartprobleme ons sister verlaat. Mag sy gaan sonder nog een zweempje daarvan.
And you shall have praise and glory for these blessings, which can only come by your name, as we minister according to your word. Amen.
En u sal lof en eer ontvang vir hierdie seëninge wat net deur die hand kan kom soos ons bedien volgens u woord. Amen. Raak haar aan, Here. Hê geloof en glo dit, suster.
Dear God, these people wrinkled hands of this dear mother as ministered to her children and her grandchildren has ministered to me many times. And she's need you this morning.
Yes.
Dierbare God, hierdie swak geplooide hande van hierdie dierbare moeder het haar kinders en haar kleinkinders bedien, en het my menige maal bedien, en sy is behoeftig vermoorde.
And we are standing as you're preaching that you're such a great God, such a great powerful God, and not a God of history, a God of present tense, I am.
En ons staan na die preek dat u so'n groot God is, so'n groot machtige God en nie een God van die geskiedenis nie, een God van die teenwoordige tyd is, ek is.
And I pray, O Lord God, that you send your blessings of healing upon her body, hands of honor in the name of Jesus. May she leave here today and get well. And live many happy years yet to serve. And we shall have all the praise for these things as she walks about and tells people of what happened. Amen.
En ek bid, o Heere, dat u seëninge van genesing op haar liggaam sal stuur, hande op haar in die naam van Jesus, mag sy hier weggaan vandag gesond word, en nog baie gelukkige jare lewe om u te dien, en u sal al die lofte ontvang vir hierdie dinge, soos jy rondloop en die mense vertel van wat gebeur het. Amen. Halleluja, Marion Williamson, God seën u. Abba van julle het my gebel, met julle gepraat.
I prayed for her several years ago with tuberculosis. She was healed, she's sick, but she has to have discernment to know just exactly what she's done or what more about it.
Ja, ek het vir haar gebid, 'n paar jaar gelede met tuberculosis, sy is genees. Sy is siek, maar sy moet onderskeiding hê om te weet net wat precies wat sy gedoen het of wat nog daarvan.
Which I do believe, oh, this young lady and them we prayed for a while ago is going to be well. I believe that with all that's in me. I just believe it. You believe it too?
Maar ek wel glo echter dat hierdie jong dame en hulle waarvoor ons gebid het, 'n tydjie gelede gaan gesond word. Ek glo dit met alles wat in my as, ek glo dit net, glo julle dit ook?
I have the same kind of feeling about them that I had about your mother, Miss Wood, see? Or like it did you, Brother Shire, and many others here. I just feel they're going to be well. That's all. They have drove a long ways and come to the service, and that shows their faith.
Ek het dieselfde soort gevoel oor hulle wat ek oor jou moeder gehad het, mevrou Wood, sien, of wat ek gehad het oor jou broer Sharon en baie ander hier. Ek voel net hulle gaan gesond wees. Dis al hulle. Hulle het ver gery en na diens toe gekom en dit wys hulle geloof.
You know the Bible speaks of that in the last days. That's right. Oh, it'll be light in the evening time. Is that right? It'll be light. The same gospel, the same Holy Spirit, the same power of God will be here to heal the sick and the afflicted as it was.
Weet julle, die Bybel praat daarvan in die laaste dag. Dis reg. O, dit sal lig word in die aandtyd. Is dit reg? Dit sal lig word dieselfde evangelie. Dieselfde Heilige Gees, dieselfde krag van God sou hier wees om die siekes en beproefdes te genees soos dit was.
And God is present right now. Present right now. He's just as present now as he will be tonight. It's the same to heal the sick and afflicted. Isn't he good?
En God is nou net teenwoordig, net nou teenwoordig. Hy is net so teenwoordig nou as wat hy vanaand sal wees, net dieselfde om siekes en beproefdes te genees. Is hy nie goed nie?
Let's sing a chorus. Wonderful Jesus is to me. Wonderful, wonderful Jesus is to me. Counselor, Prince of Peace, Mighty God is He. Let's sing it now together.
Kom ons sing 'n akkoord hierdie, wonderlik is Jesus vir my, sister Kenneth, wonderlik, wonderlik is Jesus vir my, raadsman, vrede voor, sterke God is hy, kom ons sing dit ons saam.
Wonderlik, wonderlik is Jesus vir my, raadsman, vrede voor, sterke God is hy, o hy wat my red, my wereld van alles, sonde en skande, wonderlik is my verlosser prij sy naam. O wonderlik, wonderlik is Jesus per my, raadsman, vrede vol, sterke God is hy. O wat my red, my weerhou van alles, sonde en skande, wonderlik is my verlosser prijs sy naam.
Heer verloren, nou gepunt, vrij van alle oordeel. Jezus geeft vrijheid en een volle redding. Hij wat me redt, mij weerhoudt van alle zonde en schande. Wonderlijk is mijn verlosser, prijs zijn naam. Wonderlijk, wonderlijk. Jesus.
Say it, everyone, now. Lift it up.
Sing dat allemaal nou, verhef dat. Wat mijn vrede voort, sterke God is heel. Wat mij redt, mij weer ook van alles zonde en schande. Wonderlijk is mijn verlosser, prijs zijn naam. Oh, wonderlijk, wonderlijk.
Raise up your hands.
Steek op je lander, wanneer mij wat vrede voort, sterke God is heel. Wat mij redt, mij weer ook van alles zonde en schande. Wonderlijk is mijn verlosser, prijs zijn naam.
Amen. Let's just raise up our hands and thank him, everyone in your own way.
Amen. Kom, ons steek net ons handen op en dank om elkeen op jouw manier.
Lord, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your mercy. For all that you have done for us. It's been good to be here.
Heer, ons dank u voor uw goedheid. Ons dank u voor uw genade. Voor alles wat u voor ons gedoen hebt. Het was goed om hier te wees.
We would say with Peter and him, let us build 3 tabernacles. One for thee, one for Moses, and one for Elias. But that blessed boy says, this is my beloved son. Hear ye him. So wonderful is Jesus, the counselor, the prince of peace, the mighty God, the everlasting Father.
Ons zal zeggen samen met Petrus en hulle, kom ons bouw 3 tabernakels, 1 voor u, 1 voor Moses, 1 voor Elia. Maar haar dierbare stem sê, dit is mijn geliefde zoon, luister naar hem, zo wonderlijk is Jesus. Die raadsman, die vrede voor die sterke God, die eeuwige Vader.
Be with us through the coming day, Lord. Bless us now. Give us a great service tonight. Bless your servants everywhere across the world.
Wees met ons die dag wat kom, Heere. Seën ons nou, gee ons een wonderlijke dienst vanavond. Seën u dienstknechten oral oor die wereld.
Bless the meetings that's coming up across the nation, Lord. Out in the San Jose, California, other places where the meetings and people are gathering now for the great services.
Sien die dienste wat kom oor die volk, Here, buiten in San Jose, California, ander plekke waar die dienste en mense nou by mekaar kom vir die groot dienste.
Be with us tonight, be it the folks at the tabernacle, all across the nation, everywhere it's called your name. Grant, Lord, that you'll be there. In Jesus' name.
Wees vanavond met ons, wees met die mense by die tabernacle, recht oor die land, ooral waar u naam genoem word, gee Heere dat u daar sal wees in Jesus naam.
I'll turn the service to the pastor, which will be 6:30 now, prayer.
Nou sal ek die dienst oorgaan die pastoor, wat sal vandaag, projection, 6:30 nou, gebedskaarte.
I would like to say that we want to take up a love offering for our brother today.
Thank you, my brother Junior, but thank you, not at all. don't do that. I feel real little. I feel real good now. You don't want me to feel any different, do you? So, thank you just the same. He was just joking. See what I'd say.
Dank je, mijn broer Junior, geliefde. Dank je glad niet. Nee, moet het niet doen niet. Moet het niet doen niet. Ik voel baie klein. Ik voel nou baie goed. Jullie toch niet. Ik moet nou anders voelen of hoe. Zo, dank je in elk geval. Hij heeft net een grap gemaakt om te kijken wat ik zal zeggen. Gaan voort.